deep right center field.
The 1-2-2 outs, runners on second and third.
Hit to deep left field. Going back is Finnick. Warning track wall. Gone. Strike three. Got him on the changeup.
A 1-0.
This ball is gone. Off the scoreboard. Patriots win.
Sunny skies here at TD Bank Ballpark. Hello, Patriot fans. Welcome to the Jewel of the Atlantic League. Middle game of a three-game weekend set between two postseason-bound squads, your homestanding Somerset Patriots and the visiting Southern Maryland Bluecrabs. The Patriots, they're red hot right now, riding a seven-game winning streak. Last night, they crushed the Bluecrabs by a final score of 8-1. Let's take a look at last night's highlights.
You couldn't ask for better weather than what we enjoyed at TD Bank Ballpark Friday night as the Somerset Patriots returned home for a three-game series against the Southern Maryland Bluecrabs. With the team riding a six-game winning streak, Lucas Irvine took the hill for Somerset, tossing six innings while allowing just one run on eight hits. Though Irvin pitched well, the story of the game was offense for Somerset as Michael Burgess got the scoring started in the bottom of the first inning.
The pitch to the lefty. It's driven a deep left center field. Going back is Jamar Walton at the warning track, at the wall. It's gone. A three-run home run to left center field by Michael Burgess. His fifth home run of the season. And for the fourth time in the last five games, the Somerset Patriots score in the first inning to arm their pitcher with an early lead. Somerset leads 3-0 here in the first.
Honestly, I was just looking to, you know, put the ball in play somewhere in the outfield. You know, I wasn't trying to do too much. And it's anytime, you know, a man get on third, less than two outs, you know, I'm just looking to put the ball in play.
The Bluecrabs cut the deficit to two in the top of the third before David Vidal extended it back out to a three-run lead in the bottom half of the inning.
The pitch to the righty. Hits a deep right field. This will get the job done. Catch will be made by Fred Lewis, tagging from third and easily scoring. He's going to be Vinny Zerillo. He'll score standing up. Patriots add a run. They lead 4-1 here in the third.
Once again, it would be Vidal coming through for the Patriots, this time in the bottom of the seventh.
The 0-2. Ground ball up the middle for a base hit. Spears scores from third. Rounding third and heading for him is Zerillo. He'll score that a throw. It's a two-out, two-strike, two-RBI single for David Vidal. That drop by Craig Maddux looms real large. Patriots now lead 6-1 here in the seventh.
Somerset would add two more runs in the bottom of the eighth inning, defeating the Bluecrabs in the series opener by a score of 8-1.
Well, fans, here on ESPN.TV, we do more than just live stream games. We also have various programming. One of our shows is Mic'd Up. Earlier this season, we mic'd up one of our great mascots, General Admission. Let's find out what he had to say.
Hey, can I high five? You remember me? Hey, can I high five? Yeah! Good evening, thank you for coming to the ballpark tonight. Yeah, all right. I want energy, I want us engaged with these fans. All right, let's get Patriots on three. 1, 2, 3, Patriots!
And don't worry about Sparky. If he tries anything dirty, we'll take care of him.
You wanna help the kid beat Sparky in the Sparky Dash today? Look at that. Ah, it's all right. You'll get him next time, Sparky.
What's up? Woo!
You guys feel like going for a skip? All right. Yay! Yay! You know, we don't do enough skipping. Hey, what's up, everybody? Woo!
Can we have your autograph?
Of course. Dale! Good afternoon, sir.
All right.
All right. Happy birthday from the Patriots.
That was totally out.
He was totally out, but they called him safe?
Yeah.
But he was totally out? Hey, what's up, bud? Woo! Yeah. Can you believe I'll be 259 this year? What's that?
That would be a beach ball.
I got a beach ball? Forget it. In a few moments, I'm going to yell Somerset. And I need you all to yell back Patriots. All right. Are we ready? 1, 2, 3. Somerset! Come on, let's go. Who wants a t-shirt? Well, I'm not in charge of firing. Ready, aim, fire! I used to fire the t-shirts, but they don't let me do that no more. Come on, who wants a t-shirt? Who wants a t-shirt? Get up! Get up! Ready, aim, fire! Yeah! Woo! Somerset! Patriots! Woo! Selfie time. Let's go!
Awesome.
All right, you're welcome. Yeah, let's get up! Get up, let's go! Somerset! Yeah, let's go! Woo! High five, bud! Yeah! One more time! Somerset! Woo! Nice.
Thank you.
You're welcome, guys. Thank you! Thank you, guys! Thank you! Thank you! Forrest, one, two, three strikes, you're out at the old ball game. Bye, everybody. See you next time.
Well, great stuff from General, who's always flanked by Sparky and Slider. When we come back, we'll have starting lineups. We'll have first pitch, and we'll have baseball right here on SPN.TV.
You got to go back to June 10th against the Camden River Sharks. It's currently July 25th. It's been about 6 weeks since the Somerset Patriots lost when he started. They're 7-0 in his last seven starts. So Z has just been an absolute beast for the Somerset Patriots. Remember, this guy started the All-Star game last year. Here is the defense behind Matt Zielinski. Left to right in the outfield, it will be Eggleston, Linton, and Burgess. Left to right around the diamond, Hopkins, Andino, Spears, Vidal, and the batter of Zielinski is Skelton. So Ollie Linton is playing center field. He was just signed yesterday by the Somerset Patriots. Vinny Zerillo takes a reserve role right now and goes on the bench. So an interesting choice to bring in Ollie Linton. He's got a lot of speed. He's a lefty. Was originally in AA with the Indians organization earlier this year. And the 29-year-old got released last month, and now he's latched on with Somerset. So he is in center field. He'll hit leadoff for the Patriots. We'll go through the Patriots' order in the bottom of the first inning. Here's Fred Lewis. Top of the first, nobody out, nobody on. We're scoreless. Lewis hitting .257, three homers, and 28 RBI. Patriots have really dominated the Blue Crabs in the Brett Jody era. The Somerset Patriots, they are 36-15 against Southern Maryland. That's since the start of the 2000. And for a called strike, it's officially go time at 7:08 p.m. Eastern Time. We are underway from the jewel of the Atlantic League. 85 degrees and gorgeous outside. The 0-1, low and in, count 1-1 in the lefty Lewis. It's 317 feet in the left field line, 315 feet in the right field line, 365 in the gaps, and 402 to dead center field. The 1-1. Foul behind home plate. Count 1-2 here to Lewis. Lewis, a former big leaguer with the Giants, Blue Jays, and Mets. Umpires for you this evening. Same three-man crew from last night. Everybody rotates clockwise. Manny Alejandro at first, Steve Leonardo at third, and the crew chief is Freddy DeJesus behind the plate. 2-2 count here to Lewis. Zielinski's never been in affiliated baseball, hard to believe. Spent 3 years in the Frontier League, second straight year in the Atlantic League. Went to University of Richmond for his undergraduate tenure, then got his master's degree from Westchester University in Pennsylvania. A 2014 All-Star. Goes up against the veteran Fred Lewis, who's also played for Lancaster and Bridgeport. High chopper to second, glove by Spears, slings it over to first, Vidal makes the catch. And there's one out in the top of the first, nobody on base, we're scoreless. Here is Casey Stevenson. Stevenson reached base all four plate appearances yesterday and went 3-for-3 with a walk. Casey hitting an even .300 this season. That's good for third best batting average amongst all active players in the Atlantic League. Only Wellington, Dotella, Bridgeport, and Aaron Eggleston of your Somerset Patriots are hitting at a higher clip than Casey Stevenson. That's why he's the number two hitter in the order. Got to get him a lot of at-bats. Fastball away, count 1-0. One out, no one on. Scoreless top of the first inning. Long set from Z. In for a called strike, count 1-1. Very good crowd on hand. Fireworks after the game. The 1-1. Breaking ball swoops in for a strike, count 1-2. Got 287 running parallel to the left field wall. The train tracks that run north to New York City parallel to the right field wall. And the American flag blowing beyond the batter's eye in dead center. Fastball up and away, count 2-2. Part of the reason why Matt Zielinski's been really effective, he's only given up one home run in his last five starts. He's keeping the ball down. This is a good crab offense, second-best team batting average in the Atlantic League. A swing and a whiff on a blistering fastball. Casey Stevenson way too late on the four-seamer, and there's two outs, top of the first. Nobody on, we're scoreless. And here comes Zach Wilson. Both these teams have qualified for the postseason, so this second half is all about tuning up for both squads, getting healthy, getting everybody in stride a little bit. Somerset's made the playoffs three straight years under Brett Jody down the first baseline. Meanwhile, the Blue Crabs, they've made the playoffs for the sixth time in 7 years. They've had three different managers the last 3 years in Pat Osborne, Lance Burkhardt, and now Stan Clyburn. Clyburn was formerly the hitting instructor for the Lancaster Barnstormers, who won the title last year. Bloop down the right field line foul. 1-2 count to the 254 hitter with four home runs. It's Zach Wilson. Clyburn's a former big league catcher with the loss with the California Angels in 1980. Then they changed to what? The Anaheim Angels. Now they're the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim. Foul behind home plate. Count 1-2. Two-strike clap will pick up here. A great crowd on hand. It'll be a 1-2 with two outs. Z shakes off Skelton. Now they agree on a sign. The 1-2. Up and in. Count 2-2. Z was the winning pitcher the night Somerset clinched the first half Liberty Division title in Camden on July 2nd. He's a big game threat. The 2-2. Swing and a miss and a high fastball. 1-2-3 go the Crabs. Z ends the inning with two strikeouts swinging. Through one half inning of play, it's none for Southern Maryland. Somerset, they're coming to bat right here on ESPN.TV and 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
Fullerton is?
View our full inventory of new Ford cars and trucks online at Fullerton.com.
And we can just throw the challenge and there's no problem.
So I think Justin's probably my biggest threat in this game right now, but I don't think he understands what's coming.
I'm just thinking about Jerry.
The crying.
Where's this immunity item? Jackpot.
And the third person voted out a survivor.
At Superguts, you can skip the wait by checking in on our mobile app or at superguts.com. We make it easy to find the right location, time, and stylist to get you ready to go. For over 100 years, CARE has offered specialized services to care for individuals suffering from psychiatric and addictive disorders. Visit www.careclinic.org to learn more. Bottom first we go. We're scoreless. Here's the starting nine for the Somerset Patriots. It will be Ollie Linton leading off in center field, hitting second Aaron Eggleston in left field, batting third Thomas Neal at DH, cleaning up David Vidal at first base, batting fifth Michael Burgess in right field, hitting sixth Robert Andino at shortstop, and 7-9 respectively, Nate Spears at second base, Greg Hopkins at third base, and James Skelton is the catcher, rounding out the order. These nine gentlemen will be facing the righty hurler for the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs, third straight year in the Atlantic League. I'm talking about Brian Grenning. 5'11", 180-pound, 30-year-old from Colorado Springs, Colorado. He has peaked at the AAA level way back in 2009, 6 years ago. On the season, 3-6 record, 4.93 ERA, 17 games, 10 starts, 65.2 innings pitched, 79 hits allowed, 46 Ks, 22 walks, a 2-1 strikeout-to-walk ratio. Opponents hitting a shade below the Mendoza line against him at 296. First pitch to Ollie Linton, making his Somerset Patriots debut, is in for a called strike. Count 0-1. So welcome to Somerset, Ollie Linton, a 5'8", 160-pound, 29-year-old center fielder from Culver City, California. Fastball away, count 1-1. Career 285 minor league hitter. This year in Double-A Akron with the Indians. Played in 16 games, got released after hitting 273, no homers, and two RBI. He's very fast. You'd love to get him on the base pass. The 1-1. Loop down the left field line foul, count 1-2. Linton was recruited to Somerset because he's really good friends with James Skelton. They're both from the California area. He was also recruited to Somerset by Kyler Newby. Ollie was drafted by the Diamondbacks in 2008, and he was in the same organization as Kyler Newby. Ground ball in the first baseline foul. Count 1-2 here to Ollie. So Ollie signed with Somerset yesterday. Didn't get in the game, and now he takes the spot of Vinny Zerillo, which is kind of ironic because it's Rutgers University night, and the guy who just graduated from Rutgers last month is not even in the starting lineup. I guess Jody's feeling just go with a little bit more of a veteran experience right now and keep Cirillo on the bench. The 1-2. Low and in. Count 2-2. Nobody out, nobody on. Bottom first, we're scoreless. The Patriots have scored at least one run in the first inning in four of their last five games. It's part of the reason why they boast a seven-game winning streak. They're getting ahead early, and they've got the best pitching staff that can maintain a lead. The 2-2. Weak number down the first baseline, fielded by the first baseman. Ollie's going to be out on the three unassisted putout. Here's the rest of the Blue Crabs defense. Left to right in the outfield, it's Rosa, Walton, Lewis. Left to right around the diamond, Stevenson, Frawley, Opitz, Wilson. The batter made of Grenning is Maddox. Well, here is Aaron Eggleston. Last night, had a fifth-inning single to extend his hitting streak to 20 games, longest by an Atlantic League player this season. Hitting .323, leads the Atlantic League in batting average. He's hit safely in 28 of his last 29 ball games. First pitch, fastball away, count 1-0. A homer and 26 RBI for the elder statesman, the lefty Aaron Eggleston. Righty pitcher, lefty batter, one out, no one on. Bottom first, we're scoreless. The pitch. In for a called strike, count 1-1. Aaron Eggleston is hitting 72 points higher this year than he did last year. A .251 hitter a year ago. Breaking ball inside, count 2-1. What a great bounce back year for a guy who contemplated retirement in the offseason. Wasn't even in the starting lineup in the postseason last year. Wasn't even in the opening day starting lineup this year. And now he might be the frontline candidate for Atlantic League MVP in 2015. Hit to deep left field. Going back is Rosa at the warning track. Makes the catch. A deep opposite field flyout to his counterpart and left by Eggleston to Rosa. Two outs. And here comes Thomas Neal. Welcome back to the lineup, Thomas Neal. The last time we saw Thomas Neal, it was July 4th. It's currently July 25th. 17 straight games Thomas has missed with a left thumb injury. But he is back. Talked to Thomas. He said he could have come back sooner, but since Somerset had already wrapped up a postseason berth after he sustained the injury, they wanted to take a very precautious approach to make sure their key cog is well rested. Neal hitting .290, four homers, and a team-high 38 RBI. Yeah, he missed 17 games, and he still leads the team in RBI. You could say this guy was an all-star snub. Low and in to the designated hitter, count 1-0, 6'2", 220-pound, 27-year-old from Glendale, Arizona. Former big leaguer with the Indians, Cubs, and Yankees. The 1-0 to the righty. Up and away, count 2-0 here to Thomas Neal. Neal's got the sixth best batting average in the Atlantic League amongst active players. At .290, the 2-0. In for a called strike, count 2-1. Grenning has faced Somerset a couple times this season. Two games, one start, no record, 4.00 ERA. The 2-1. In for a called strike. That looked above the letters. Count 2-2. This is Thomas's first live action since July 4th. The 2-2. Low and away, 3-2. And this is good for Neal. He's seeing a lot of pitches. And when you haven't seen live pitching in 3 weeks, the best remedy to get back in the swing of things is take pitches and see what's in the pitcher's arsenal, get acclimated to the baseball environment. The 3-2. Foul behind home plate near the entrance plaza. It'll be another payoff pitch. Two outs, no one on. Bottom first, we're scoreless. Somerset trying to score in the first inning for the fifth time in the last six games. Got to start a two-out rally, though. The 3-2. Called strike three, nip the outside corner. Neal down looking on a seven-pitch strikeout at bat. Through one inning of play, we're scoreless. To the second we go on the New Talk Radio 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
Somerville Aluminum sets the standard for best in class. For over three generations, we've seen products changing, processes changing, What hasn't changed about us is who we are.
From our home to yours, we invite you to explore our new state-of-the-art showroom and visualize your dream. We want you to touch and experience the latest products so you can make the best choices. From kitchens and baths to windows, doors, and siding, we have it all.
This month, get 10% off siding and roofing projects.
Your wrist bone's connected to your x-ray. Your x-ray's connected to your orthopedist. Your orthopedist is connected to the OR. The OR's connected to your blood work.
With RWJ Health Connect, your secure electronic medical records are connected to your hospitals, doctors, and to the Robert Wood Johnson Health System.
And RWJ's connected to you. Register online for RWJ Health Connect. Better access for better health.
Call Wellman Home Service today for an $89 air conditioning tune-up. WellmanHomeServices.com is the website. The phone number is 888-WELLMAN. Shopping for a new car? Hit a home run with all the great deals available now at your Tri-State Ford dealer. Proud sponsor of Somerset Patriots baseball. Visit TriStateFord.com for more information today. We go to the top of the second. We're scoreless here on SPN.TV and WCTC, one of our 20 simulcasts on our media network home for the Somerset Patriots. It'll be Opitz, Molina, and Rosa. Each team went down in order. Zielinski and Grenning off to good starts, the pitchers. First pitch to Opitz is in for a called strike. Count 0-1 here to the Colorado native. Six homers, 19 RBI, 265 average for the lefty second baseman. Third straight year with the Crabs. Swing and a miss. Count 0-2. The 0-2 from Zielinski rocks fires. Breaking ball downstairs, count 1-2. It's time for the Fleming Car and Truck Country Family of Dealerships upcoming events calendar. Well, Somerset, this is a rare home series for them. They're in the midst of playing 14 of 17 on the road. These are the only three games at home. Low and away, count 2-2. So a lot of Atlantic League room service over the last 3 weeks for these gentlemen. Which they don't mind because Somerset actually boasts the second best home record, but the best road record in the Atlantic League. Only Long Island wins at a higher clip at home, but Somerset's 30-11 on the road. They actually enjoy it, and they'll be going to Long Island and Lancaster coming up. Fastball away, count 3-2 here to Opitz. So we'll have the series finale tomorrow night, 5 o'clock. We'll be on air, 5:05 first pitch. It's a leadoff walk and a curveball down away. First base runner for either team. One on, no one out. Top second, we're scoreless. And here comes Molina. And then Somerset will have a well-deserved off day on Monday. It'll actually be their first off day of the second half, believe it or not. First off day since the All-Star break. And then, like I just mentioned, then they go to Long Island and then to Lancaster. Yeah, we go to Long Island again. Three times we go to Long Island this month. It's just refreshing the fact that Somerset's seeing a team that's not Camden or Long Island. Prior to last night's game, the last time Somerset faced a team that wasn't Camden and Long Island, it was June 28th. Last night was July 24th. Found that even behind home play 1-1. Six straight series they played between Camden and Long Island. They alternated back and forth. Which on one hand, you're playing the second best team in the Atlantic League. On the other hand, you're maybe playing the worst team in the Atlantic League. So I guess it all evens out, but it just kind of got redundant after a while. Even the guys in the clubhouse were begging to play a new team. It just gets old. You know, you want a new challenge. Popped up behind home plate foul. Count 1-2 here to Molina. Molina's one of the MVP candidates in the league. Look, I think Aaron Eckelson's your number one candidate. I think your number two candidate's Lou Ford. I think your number three candidate's Gustavo Molina. He's top five in the league in batting average, home runs, and RBI. 296, 11, and 42, respectively. Usually is the everyday catcher getting a half day off with the DH duties tonight. But he's so good, they still want his bat in the lineup. So that's why he's DHing. Swing and a miss, and the breaking ball. Strike three. Zielinski has struck out three of the first four outs in this game. One out, one on. Patriots lead. Patriots and Crabs are scoreless in the top of the second inning. And here comes Jovan Rosa. You can tell Zielinski's locked in because he's got three strikeouts and they're all swinging, so guys can't even touch his stuff. The 1-2. The scoreboard did not reset. In for a called strike. Count 0-1. Runner on first, one out. Somerset's been turning a lot of double plays lately. The other day against Camden, they turned four double plays from the first seven innings. You'd love a twin killer right here for Rosa to bounce into. This ball is laced down the left field line. It's going to be fair. It'll one hop off the wall. Stopping at third is going to be Opitz. So no double play, but there was a double hit down the left field line. Runners on second and third, one out. And here's Jamar Walton, a 2015 All-Star. Let's see how Jody aligns his defense here. Second and third, one out. Top of the second, we're scoreless. I think he might play the infield back. Look, the Somerset offense has been firing on all cylinders. They've scored at least eight runs in four of their last five games. And he will play the infield back. So they'll give up a run in exchange for an out. Ground ball on the first baseline, foul. Count 0-1. One out, runners on second and third. Walton hitting .289, two homers, and 26 RBI. Seventh best batting average in the Atlantic League for the All-Star. Former Florida Marlins product. Now they're the Miami Marlins. The 0-1. Low and away, count 1-1. This is when Irvin was able to bear down yesterday. Got out of jams in the first, third, and fifth innings with runners in scoring position. And opponents only hit .214 with runners in scoring position against Zielinski. The 1-1 here. Found an ending behind on play 1-2. Now Z's got to try and put him away. The last time the Somerset Patriots trailed, it was 7 days ago. It was in the ninth inning as they trailed 5-4 against Ryan Kusmall and the Long Island Ducks. And that was when Eggleston had the game-winning two-out, two-strike, two-RBI double. And that jump started the seven-game winning streak. Ground ball back to Zielinski. He knocks it down. Throw to first is going to be in time. He got him. A run does score in the RBI ground out. Nice pick by Vidal at first. Good job by Zielinski just to stab that ball and knock it down. Otherwise, it would have been a two-RBI single. If Z had fielded it cleanly, he could have come home as the runner from third was going on contact. But it's an RBI ground out for Jamar Walton. And that's his 27th RBI of the season. And the Crabs take a 1-0 lead. A hard one-hopper back to Z, knocked it down with the palm of his glove, pounced on it through to first. Vidal picked it on a short hop. Staying at second is going to be Rosa. Scoring from third is Opitz. So nothing too sexy right there, but the Crabs score first. The Patriots trail for the first time since the ninth inning on Saturday. Wow. That's how dominant Somerset's been. Lefty-on-lefty matchup here. Here's Craig Maddux. He dropped two pop-ups behind home plate yesterday. Foul down the left field line. Hopkins giving it a look near the camera well, and it goes on top of the Crab dugout foul.
Hey fans, Nissan is an easier choice than ever with the most exciting and fuel-efficient lineup. Get great offers across their full line. Shop at your local Nissan store and choose Nissan.com.
So lefty-on-lefty matchup. A lot of lefties in this lineup. Five lefties in the lineup against the lefty Zielinski. Kind of an odd composition. You would think you would load your lineup with righties when you're facing a tough southpaw and a savvy southpaw in Matt Zielinski. Slider away, check swing, did he go? No, he did not, says Steve Leonardo. Two outs, runner on second. It'll be a 1-2 count. Slider away, count 2-2. Breaking ball called strike three. Hits the outside corner. Z limits the damage. One run scores in an RBI ground out. Crabs lead 1-0. Bottom second we go on the New Talk Radio 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
All at exceptional values. Flemington's highly trained furniture experts are not on commission, so you can experience a pressure-free and informative shopping experience. Come explore the best-kept secret in New Jersey at the Flemington Department Store on Route 31 in Flemington.
What's better than winning Dealer Raiders Dealer of the Year Award? Winning it back-to-back. That's right. Flemington Car and Truck Country is New Jersey's Dealer Raider Dealer of the Year 2 years in a row. So thank you to our customers for putting us on top again. Visit DealerRaider.com to read our reviews. Over 1 million satisfied customers can't be wrong. 17 brands, 6,000 vehicles in one location. Flemington Car and Truck Country family of dealerships.
Proud to be the better way to buy.
Great. HealthQuest is the official sponsor of the Somerset Patriots. Fitness, sports, family, wellness, and community. Affinity Federal Credit Union. Banking, investing, advising. Learn how you can borrow something better at www.joinaffinity.com. Bottom second, 1-0. Crabs lead. Middle of the order due up, Vidal, Burgess, and Andino for the Somerset Patriots. How good has Dave Vidal been? 7 RBI in his last two ball games. 4 on Thursday afternoon in that series sweep over Camden as the Patriots clinched the Turnpike Cup that afternoon. And then he had 3 more last night in the 8-1 drubbing over Southern Maryland. David hitting 279. He really is a cut above the rest. From Hialeah, Florida, right in the Miami area. 5'11", 212 pounder, just 25 years old. He'll turn 26 in October. Has peaked at the AA level, 36 RBI, second most in the team. 7 in his last two games. First pitch is in for a called strike, count 0-1. You know, David Vidal began the year as a bottom of the order type hitter. But once Chris Marrero left to go to the White Sox organization in AA, now he's in AAA, Vidal's season turned around because it allowed Vidal to move up in the lineup. Jody gave him a lot of confidence, and he's been raking. I mean, you could say this guy was an all-star snub. The 1-1, breaking ball away, count 2-1. What I love about Vidal, he's so selective at the plate. I mean, rarely is he going to get out on one or two pitches. He's going to make this pitcher work. 1-0 Crabs lead, bottom second, nobody out, nobody on. Righty pitcher, righty batter. The 2-1 here to the first baseman. It's stroked to deep right field. Going back is Fred Lewis. 2 feet in front of the warning track, he'll haul it in, fighting the sun with his black glove. And there's one out. Four up, four down thus far for Grenning. Here is Michael Burgess. Burgess was the offensive star last night, particularly in the first inning when he slugged a 3-run home run. Burge is hitting 246, 5 homers, and 25 RBI. Burge is one of those really streaky players. And he's in one of those hot zones right now. Swing and a miss, count 0-1. Burge is one of the few guys in this team that actually did not begin the year on the roster. He began the year in AA with the Orioles organization. For the most part, the Patriots have kept their nucleus intact. The 0-1, swing and a miss, count 0-2. Sparky and Slider, our mascots, hyping everybody up. It'll be an 0-2 here to Burgess whenever Grenning's ready to throw this baseball. fouling that in behind home plate, 0-2. This is Grenning's third straight year in the Atlantic League. Hasn't had too much success. I mean, this year's ERA is 4.93 in 17 outings, 10 starts. His career Atlantic League record is 12-21. He pitched for Lancaster all of 2013. Last year he began the year with Lancaster, was traded about this time last year to Southern Maryland, and he's pitched for Southern Maryland since the start of this season in April. The 0-2 here to Grenning, from Grenning to Burgess. Check swing, did he go? No, he did not. Count 1-2. Grenning's a former 38th round draft pick in 2008 by the Cleveland Indians at a Cal Poly Tech State University. Not exactly a school known for its baseball prowess, but he was an athletic specimen coming out of that school. The 1-2. Foul behind home plate. We'll do it again. Crabs are in their gray jerseys. Patriots are in their white uniforms. It's Rutgers University Day here at the ballpark. We had Kyle Flood throughout the first pitch. Fourth-year head coach for the Rutgers football team. Curveball away. Count 2-2. No guarantees. We're hoping Coach Flood can join us sometime during the course of this evening. I know he's a busy man. There's a lot of media members here that want to catch up with him. Fall practices are going to begin first week of August. Second year in the Big Ten for Rutgers, so maybe we'll catch up with him. If not, you can hear the Kyle Flood Show on CTC once a week this fall. And you'll hear a lot of Rutgers football games every Saturday right here. They'll even bump us off the air a couple times, I'm sure. It'll be a 3-2 here to Burgess. Foul behind home plate. This has been a long at bat. This has been a really long at bat here. Burgess was down in the count 0-2. Now all of a sudden it's 3-2, and he's just fouled off a couple. One out, no one on. Patriots trail 1-0. Well, look, this is what Somerset does. They give up some runs, and they seem to get them right back, usually within the next half inning. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up here to Michael Burgess, the lefty slugger. Foul behind home plate. Michael just cannot straighten something up right now. It'll be a 3-2 count. Ninth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Grenning long set. Wheels fires. This ball is hit to right field, medium right field. It was off the end of the bat. And the catch is easily corralled by Fred Lewis in medium right field. Five up, five down for Grenning. Two outs here in the second. Patriots down a run, and here's Robert Andino. You know, life is good for the Somerset Patriots, who are a season-high 36 games above 500, riding a seven-game winning streak, already going to the postseason for the third time in as many years. They've already won the Turnpike Cup. When the worst thing in the world was that Robert Andino snapped his six-game multi-hit game streak. Last night he only had one hit. Poor Robert. Swing and a miss. Count 0-1. Season high seven game hitting streak though. I mean, how about his average? 262. I remember when this guy was hitting 161. I remember when this guy had more errors than hits. We were all worried about Robert Andino. Check swing grounder back to the pitcher. An excuse me accidental swing right there by Andino. And he grounds out on a 1-3 put out. And Grenning's been perfect through two. Through two innings of play, Crabs lead 1-0. To the third we go on ESPN.TV and 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
Go! Fans, make some noise. Allow me to get the faster way. Go!
coming down the right field line. He gets hit from it today. All right, after you're done going to the batter up funnel cake stand, take a look at the left field line. You see the star right, you see general admission, and many more out there. And also at Johnson University Hospital, comfort seating section. Everything the people had a family understands. And they get upgraded. And there's lovely seats down the left field line. They're nice little long. They got those lawn seats. And we have a voucher for 4 free hot dogs, sodas, and french fries all from Ronald at Johnson University Hospital. The campuses in Somerville and New Brunswick, both America's best hospitals, and all from EZU.edu. Leading off for the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs, the number 9 hitter, the shortstop, number 4, Casey Frawley.
Innovation that excites, choose Nissan at Nissan.com. We'll do this quickly here, and then we'll get back to this game. Rebs and Sharks tied at 1 in the 4th inning in York. Stormers blanking the Skeeters in the 2nd inning in Texas. Bluefish doubling up the Ducks 2-1 in the 6th inning. Want to send our thoughts and well wishes to Dave Collins, the broadcaster for the Lancaster Barnstormers. He's sick in the hospital in Texas. He's unable to broadcast the games. Sounds like, according to the team Facebook page, everything's going well with Dave, but obviously it was severe enough for him to go to the hospital. So everybody here in the Atlantic League is family. We wish him a quick and speedy recovery. Check swing, did he go? I think he definitely did. Wow, he did not. How did not go, Manny Alejandro? Count 1-2. To Casey Frawley. Frawley's struggling, just 3 for his last 29. It'll be a 1-2 top of the 3rd. Nobody out, nobody on. Line in the ending behind home plate. Cole Hamels threw a no-hitter today at Wrigley Field against the Chicago Cubs. That's got to help his trade stock, as the Phillies are definitely out of it, and he's on the market. And the Yankees are trailing 2-0 to the Twins early. Mets leading 4-0 against the Dodgers early. Fly ball to right, not even moving a muscle. No exaggeration as Michael Burgess sticks his black glove up, finds a white pearl inside, and there's one out here. All right, second time for the order here. Here comes Fred Lewis. Can't say enough good things about the job that Brett Jody and his two assistants and Corey Dommel and Shane Spencer have done, not only this year, but last year as well, and the year before. 90 wins in 2013, 85 wins last year. I mean, they're on pace for 100 wins this year. It's just remarkable. I'm telling you, folks, baseball's not supposed to be this easy. It's certainly a lot harder than these guys are making it. They're making it seem pretty easy and mundane and routine. This is a game of failure. You're successful if you fail 70% of the time. And Somerset is just winning at a rapid rate. They're kind of spoiling the fan base. I mean, right now, there's 2 months of the postseason. Breaking ball called strike 3. Nips the outside corner. Lewis down looking. The biggest concern is who's going to pitch the 7th inning come game 1 of the postseason. What's going to be your pitching rotation? And getting guys like Kelly and Harden and Tucker healthy. You just got Neil healthy. He's in the lineup today. So you need the other 3 guys to get healthy. And then what happens when the Mexican League ends? Are you going to bring over some guys from the Mexican League? Somerset usually does. Last year they brought Josh Lowey over and Jake Fox. Inside, count 1-0. And remember, Buddy Beauchiers is still missing. He's been gone the last two weeks due to personal family reasons. He's back home in Alabama listening to this broadcast, maybe even watching it. Hopefully you get those situations resolved, Buddy. I mean, the Pens doing just fine without you. But Buddy Beauchiers was automatic in the 8th inning. Buddy Beauchiers had a sub-1 ERA. Two outs, no one on, top 3rd. 1-2 can here, the lefty, Casey Stevenson. Zielinski's been great. I think Zielinski would be my number 2 starter if the postseason started this coming weekend. I would go Bierman, Zielinski, Irvin, Boone, Story. The 1-2. Loop down the left field line, foul. And honestly, if you went the reverse, if you went Story, Boone, Irvin, Zielinski, Bierman, I think you could win just as easily. It just goes to show you pick a name of a hat and you'll be A-OK. But right now, you know, you ask me, that's what I would go with.
mean, Bierman's probably going to win pitcher of the year at this rate. The 1-2. Ground ball right back to Z on one hop. Gloves it, doesn't fumble it this time. Throw to first well in. Bottom third coming up. Patriots trail 1-0. On the New Talk Radio, 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com. BRB.
Check your mailbox. You could find money in it. Money Mailer could be in your mailbox right now. You'll find great offers from local area businesses you know and trust, including the Somerset Patriots. You can also find all of these offers and many more at moneymailer.com or on our new convenient Money Mailer app for Android and iPhone users. So start saving money now and look for your Money Mailer envelope, which might be in your mailbox today.
From live sports and event streaming to creative and compelling commercial production, utilizing cutting-edge technology invented and refined over the past decade, Broadcast Venue specializes in guiding New Jersey through the digital age. Our customized, state-of-the-art mobile broadcasting unit allows for a versatile, uninterrupted broadcast to coincide with a crisp, clear picture that can be viewed on your phone, tablet, or computer.
For complete family eye care, go with the Patriots. Go see Dr. Ivy Ehrlich and Dr. Martin Storbeck at the Bridgewater Optometric Center of Pearl Vision, located in the Somerset Shopping Center. You can call them at 908-685-0794. Hey, Patriot fans, enter into a hospitality suite for you and 29 of your closest friends, courtesy of Somerville Aluminum. Enter now through August 12th at somervillealuminum.com/sweeps. Well, Rude by Magic is playing over the loudspeaker. That means Nate Spears is batting. He's picked that walk-up song because that's his son's favorite song. His son is Nate Jr., and his son always gets excited when that song comes on the radio. That's what Nate told me. It's ironic because Nate's the most polite guy on the team, yet his walk-up song is Rude by Magic. Fastball away, count 1-0. Nate picked up a pair of hits last night. Average of 273, a homer, and 16 RBI. Crabs lead 1-0, bottom third. Nobody out, nobody on. The lefty, second baseman. Nate's put a little bit of right field as well this year. He's one of many versatile assets in the Somerset Patriots. You got a lot of guys that can play a lot of different positions. Skelton and Vidal and Hopkins and Spears. They're jacks of all trade. They're Swiss Army knives. The 1-1. Swing and a miss. Count 1-2. Grenning's retired the first six batters he's faced. He's really locked in. The 1-2 here to the Spears. Grenning kicks, fires. Looped into shallow right field. Backpedaling is the second baseman. A little bit too much hang time. And the catch is made by Opitz. 7 up, 7 down. Here comes Greg Hopkins. Your lineup's pretty good when Greg Hopkins is hitting 8th in the order. Hopkins has really been a predominant, 4-5-6 hitter in the order. But he's hitting 8th right now. Just the 8th time all year Greg Hopkins is hitting in the 8 hole. Greg Hopkins has hit anywhere from 3rd to 9th in the order this season. The only things he has not done is lead off and hit 2nd. You stick him anywhere in the rotation and you're going to be successful. In for a called strike to the hopper, count 0-1. Part of the really young nucleus of this team. The best player is the elder statesman, Aaron Eggleston at 34, but the crux and core of this team, they're all young. Bierman's 26, Irvin's 26, Hopkins is 26, Caiazzo's 26, Boshiers is 27, Vidal's 25. The 1-1, in for a called strike, count 1-2. But I think there's a good mix. I mean, the nucleus is really young. You've got some older, wiser, savvy veterans. Like a Tucker, like a Hunton, like an Eggie, like a Donnie, like a Skelton. Guys who have been around for a while. It's a well-put-together squad. And the chemistry is just at an all-time high. And it seems like all the newcomers they bring in, are high-character guys as well. I mean, Ollie Linton's a class act. He just signed yesterday. Zerillo and Jose Garcia, they're very humble rookies. The 1-2 upstairs. 2-2 count, one out, no one on. 1-0, Crabs lead. Bottom of the third inning. Difference in this game is an RBI ground out by Jamar Walton, a 2015 All-Star, back in the second. This is the first time Somerset's trailing in 7 days. Ground ball to first, and a tricky one-hop, and it's misplayed by the first baseman, Wilson. That should be a base hit. That was funky spin. We'll see how they officially score it. That should be a base hit. It's kind of a funky hop right there for the first baseman, Wilson. Kind of caught in between, couldn't quite square it up and glove it. And Hopkins bloops one down the right field line. Have not made a call yet. I hope it's a single. We've got to give hometown scoring here. You know, when in doubt, I feel like the home team should get the hit. Nonetheless, it's the first base runner. Call still has not been made, so we'll wait till that is flashed on the scoreboard. Here is James Skelton. Skelton hits .313 against his former squad. It is a base hit. So first hit of the game for Somerset. James hitting .255, no homers, 19 RBI. He's familiar with Gredding. He was Grenning's battery mate last year when Skelton was in Lancaster and Southern Maryland. And James bunts this one foul, count 0-2. And you got to feel like you get up when you face your former team. And I've talked with James about this. He says he is extra motivated when he plays a team like Southern Maryland or Lancaster, two teams that didn't want him after he had suited up for both of them. He says he respects both teams, but deep inside, he gets a little extra amped up. The 0-2 to the All-Star catcher. Fist into the netting behind home plate, count 0-2. James will turn 30 years old in October. And both the catchers, Donnie and Skelton, have just done a great job of commanding this pitching staff. I mean, you'd much rather have a catcher that calls a great game and plays great defense and holds and shuts down the running game than a great offensive catcher. I mean, great offensive catchers, it's a rarity nowadays. I mean, you have your Buster Posey's and your Yadier Molina's, but for the most part, they're all really known for their defense and game calling. Particularly here in the Atlantic League. You know, the best catcher is probably Gustavo Molina of Southern Maryland. But none of the other catchers in this league can really mash. And Somerset's lineup so potent, you don't need everybody to hit over 300. You don't need this team to be the 1998 Yankees. The 0-2, runner on first, one out. 1-0 Patriots trail, bottom third. The pitch, Hopkins in the move. It's a pitch out, throw to second is going to be not in time. Wow. How fast is Greg Hopkins? A pitch out. Clyburn guessed right, but Maddox could not gun down Greg Hopkins. And Hopkins' jersey's all muddy, that head first slide. I guess they watered the field a little bit too much, but it's all right. Kevin Easton will get to work in that jersey tonight after the game. He's the home clubhouse attendant. Great guy. That was just the third steal of the year for the Hopper. So that takes away the double play threat. 1-2 count here to James. Runner on second, one out. Tying run in scoring position. Swing and a miss and a breaking ball. Strike three. So two outs, runner on second. Tying run 180 feet away. And here comes Ollie Linton, who's looking for his signature Somerset moment, despite the fact this is just his second ever Somerset Patriot at bat. Let's pause for 10 seconds. Station identification on the Somerset Patriots Baseball Radio Network. Runner on second, two outs. Ollie Linton in his first ever Patriot at bat, grounded out to first base. 5'8", 160-pound lefty from Culver City, California. Began the year in Double-A with the Indians organization. Hit .273 in 16 games, got released. Now he's playing for the Red, White, and Blue, the winningest franchise in Atlantic League history. Can Ollie officially become a Patriot in his second ever at bat? First pitch, fastball away, count 1-0. Ollie went to UC Irvine, where he was a 13th round pick in 2008 by the Arizona Diamondbacks. He has peaked at the AA level with the Indians and D-backs organizations. The 1-0, tying run on second. Hopkins is going to try and steal third. Fastball away, throw to third, not in time. Wow. Greg Hopkins had three steals all year. He's got two in this inning. Swipes second on a pitch out, and he swipes third. And he swipes third with a lefty batting. And it's hard to steal third when a lefty's batting because the catcher has a clear path and clear vision over to third. There's no body distracting him. Good stuff from the hopper. Infield back, though, with two outs. It'll be a 2-0 here to Linton. Breaking ball snaps in for a strike. Count 2-1 here to Ollie Linton, who hasn't even been here for 48 hours. At UC Irvine, Linton majored in sociology and minored in management and African American studies. The 2-1 here to Ollie. Low and in, 3-1. If you put Ollie on, then you got the best hitter in the Atlantic League coming up in Aaron Engelson in the midst of a 20-game hitting streak. Tying run 90 feet away, two outs. Bottom third, Patriots trail 1-0. Ollie Linton in his second ever at bat with the Somerset Patriots, trying to come through. And he golfs this one into left field. Backpedaling is Jovan Rosa. Three steps, squeezes the ball with two hands, makes the catch, thread over. The two stolen bases by Greg Hopkins are wasted. A third of the way through this contest, Patriots trail 1-0. To the fourth we go on the New Talk Radio, 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
The Somerset Patriots are set to host their 16th annual Charity Golf Classic this summer on Tuesday, August 4th at Neshannock Valley Golf Course in Neshannock Station. There's still time to sign up to participate in this great event. Each golfer will have an opportunity to play alongside a member of the Somerset Patriots baseball team, along with added exposure for your business throughout the course. Golfers will be treated to a delicious barbecue for lunch, beverages on the course, and a great cocktail hour and dinner served after a great day of golf. Participants will also have the chance to win great prizes. Along with golfing sponsorships, there are many other opportunities to help support this outing as well. Proceeds from the event will benefit both the Hugs for Brady Foundation and the Somerset Patriots Children's Educational and Sportsmanship Foundation. Act fast, as the space is limited for this annual tradition. Sponsors will be treated on a first-come, first-served basis as last year's event sold out. So call the Patriots and ask for Dave Merrick at 908-252-0700, extension 217, or visit SomersetPatriots.com to find out how you can participate today.
Just got official word. Sanofi is an integrated global healthcare leader with U.S. headquarters in Bridgewater, New Jersey. We work to prevent and treat the diseases we know about today as well as those we may face tomorrow. The Somerset County Education Association supports outstanding public school employees that make your child's education possible. We're in the top of the fourth inning. The Patriots trail 1-0. It'll be Wilson, Opitz, and Molina due up. Z has already five strikeouts through three innings of play. Each team has one hit. Difference in this game, though, is an RBI ground out by Jamar Walton. Here's Wilson, number three hitter in the order, swinging a whiff. He's one of five strikeout victims. He's peaked at the AA level, hitting 253 this year, four homers, 26 RBI, count 0-1. Just got word from our public relations staff that Kyle Flood will join me in the top of the fifth inning on the broadcast. Ground ball to short, throw is high, pulls Vidal off the bag, but he provides the swipe tag as Wilson was running by. So Vidal bails Andino out of an error, and there's one out here in the top of the fourth inning. So it'll be good to catch up with Coach Flood. It's Rutgers University Day here at the ballpark. We're honoring RU as they begin their 2015-2016 athletic and academic calendar year. We tried our hardest to get Carly Lloyd to Somerset. She's a popular woman, as you can expect, the hero of the World Cup earlier this month. You don't want to say Kyle Flood's a consolation prize because he's an awesome guy. Actually, I've never met him, but anybody who's ever been around him has nothing but great things to say. I'm looking forward to meeting him. But he's a pretty brand name, and people love him around here. I mean, he's shaking hands and kissing babies out here, so it'll be fun stuff to talk a little Big Ten, So Rutgers, I mean, how good has Rutgers been? They've been to four straight bowl games. They've been to a bowl game 9 of the last 10 years. They're producing guys in the NFL. Fly ball to deep left. Is it in the park for Eggleston? 1 foot on the warning track, 1 foot on the grass. He makes the catch, two outs. Opitz is retired. Opitz had scored the only run. He had a leadoff walk in the second, came around to score in the RBI ground out by Walton. So 2 outs, no one on, top four. Crabs nurse a 1-0 lead. Here's Molina, who's one of 5 strikeout victims. So here's Molina. Molina had 2 strikeouts yesterday, already a K today. Foul behind home plate, count 0-1. Now, Gustavo Molina, it's just very ironic. His last name's Molina, and he's a catcher. He is not at all related to Benji, Yadier, or Jose. 3 great catchers in the modern era. 2 are retired. 1 is a perennial MVP candidate and a perennial all-star with the Cardinals, Yadier. But they've all won World Series. Benji with the Angels, Jose with the Yankees, and Yadi with the Cardinals. Fastball away, count 1-2, but Gustavo Molina is not related to him, which is very ironic. He's a very good catcher. He's playing DH today, and his last name is Molina. The 1-2. Up and away, count 2-2. Nobody on base here. Fly ball, foul side of first. Skelton tossing away the mask, makes the catch with one hand, inning over. Near the on-deck circle, the Patriots. Through 3.5, 1-0, the Patriots trail. Bottom four coming up on ESPN.TV and 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
Come play with us! BSC has the only 4-level fantasy-themed laser tag arena in the country. Drop in for a game or book your next family fun outing and experience the best laser tag in New Jersey. Arcade games for all ages. Win tickets and take home great prizes, just like the shore. BSC also offers exciting party options in a fun and unique environment. Sports leagues, camps, and child development programs. BSC has something for everyone.
Stop by and join the excitement.
What's better than winning Dealer Raiders Dealer of the Year Award? Winning it back-to-back. That's right. Flemington Car and Truck Country is New Jersey's Dealer Raider Dealer of the Year 2 years in a row. So thank you to our customers for putting us on top again. Visit DealerRaider.com to read our reviews. Over 1 million satisfied customers can't be wrong. 17 brands, 6,000 vehicles in one location. Flemington Car and Truck Country family of dealerships.
Proud to be the better way to buy.
Somerset Hills Memorial Park and Mausoleum is the proud sponsor of the Somerset Patriots True Patriot Promotion. They are conveniently located off 287 in Basking Ridge, New Jersey. Somerset Hills Memorial Park offers peace, respect, and dignity to those we serve. Looking for a great deal in a car? You'll score big savings at your Tri-State Ford dealer. Proud sponsor of Somerset Patriots Baseball. Visit tristateford.com for more information today. Bottom four, Patriots trail 1-0. They got the right guys coming up, Eggleston, Neal, and Vidal. Aaron is 0-for-1 with a flyout to deep left field. Aaron is in the midst of a 20-game hitting streak. Needs to balloon that to 21. He'll get a couple more at-bats throughout this one. A well-pitched game thus far. Grenning's only allowed one hit, so is Zielinski. Breaking ball in for a called strike, 0-1 here to the front runner for the MVP award in this league, Aaron Eggleston. Leads the league with a .321 batting average. Homer and 26 RBI. Inside, count 1-1. Aaron turned 34 years old earlier this month from Las Vegas, Nevada. Third straight year with the Patriots. Also played briefly for York at the tail end of 2009. Curveball loops in for a strike, count 1-2. And Aaron's not a guy who's not afraid to hit with 2 strikes. He's got a great approach, great game plan. He plays with a lot of confidence. The 0-2. Goff down the first baseline foul, spoiling a tough one to stay alive. Look, that's what good hitters do. They spoil tough pitches and wait for mistake pitches to bounce on. Fourth-year head coach for the Rutgers football program will join me next inning. It's Kyle Flood. It'll be a 1-2 here to Eccleston. And now Grenning wants a new baseball. Gorgeous day, 85 degrees and pleasant outside. Great crowd on hand. It'll be a 1-2. Outside, count 2-2. Long set from Grenning, the 2-2. Low and away, 3-2. Great at bat here by Aggie. Down in the count, now he's worked it full at 3-2. Had a full count his first time up before he flew out to left field. Aaron sitting at a 20-game hitting streak. Can he extend it to 21, a league high? Low and in, he walked him. Tying run on first, and the 3-4-5 hitters are coming up, starting with Thomas Neal. This is Neal's first game since July 4th. He had missed 17 games with a left thumb injury. He injured the thumb just swinging. It wasn't like he was hit by a pitch or got jammed on a grounder or anything like that. He was just taking some hacks in the cage, and he kind of felt his thumb kind of pop out of place a little bit. Had a couple MRIs, a little swelling. Said he could have come back a little bit sooner, but since Somerset had already wrapped up a postseason berth, there's no need to rush a key cog back. He's 100% healthy right now. Eggie on the move. First pitch high. Throw to second is not in time. Somerset running wild on Maddox. Somerset had three steals last night. They already have three steals in this one. And we're in the bottom of the fourth inning with a runner on second. Nobody out. We saw Hopkins steal twice last inning. So Neal's job right now, hit the ball the other way on the ground to the right side. Move Eggie to third and get the tying run 90 feet away. For Vidal, who's on deck, who's got 7 RBI in his last two games. Swing and a miss, count 1-1. This is a pretty good 3-4 combo in the middle of the order. Combined, Neal and Vidal have 74 RBI. It'll be a 1-1 here to T-Daddy. First game back since July 4th. And he fists this one to shallow right field. Back penalty is the second baseman. He'll haul it in. Unproductive out right there as Eggleston has to stay at second as the ball was hit on a fly to the second baseman. And here is Vidal. David this season, second to the team in RBI with 36, hitting .278, a pair of home runs, 7 RBI in his last two games, 4 on Thursday, 3 on Friday. He's a cut above the rest. Flew out to deep right field his first time up. David has peaked at the AA level. Has played winter ball in Puerto Rico before, low and away, count 1-0. Went to college at Miami-Dade Community College. Hunton's uncle was the hitting instructor at Miami-Dade Community College and gave Hunton a very good review on Vidal. That's how Vidal ended up landing in Somerset because of Hunton's family. It's all about connections. Upstairs, count 2-0 here. Runner on second, one out. 1-0 Patriots trail in the bottom of the fourth inning. It'll be a 2-0 here to Vidal. From Grenning. The 2-0. In for a called strike, count 2-1. Usually Vidal takes on 2-0. He's very, very selective. It'll be a 2-1 here to the righty against the righty Grenning. Two-seamer sails too far down and in, count 3-1. The 3-1 is low and away, and he walked him. So here comes Burgess. Burgess smacked a 3-run homer yesterday. The Patriots had one base runner through the first three innings. They've got two in this fourth inning alone. They trail 1-0, bottom of the fourth. Two on, one out here for Burgess. Force anywhere except home. Righty pitcher, lefty batter. Eggleston on second, Vidal on first. They both walked. Neal popped up to second in between them. First pitch. Foul and netting behind home plate. Count 0-1 here to Michael Burgess, who does have aspirations of being a pitcher a little bit later on this year. He's been throwing some bullpens with Corey Dommel and Brett Jody. He was a great pitcher in high school, and he kind of wants to reinvent the wheel. He still wants to hit, but he wants to be a pitcher too. Now look, I don't see Michael Burgess pitching in the postseason, but when you wrapped up a postseason berth in the first half, you can experiment with things in the second half, kind of like what Somerset did with Corey Haralchek last summer. 0-1. Low and in. Count 1-1 here. One out. Two on. Bottom four. Patriots trail 1-0. This is the penultimate game between Somerset and Southern Maryland this season. After tomorrow, they will not see each other for the rest of the regular season. Now, this could be a potential championship series preview, as both teams have qualified for the postseason by winning their respective halves. But 1-1. Hit to deep center field. Going back is Walton at the warning track. Back against the wall, he makes the catch. And the runners have to go back to first and second. Literally, it's 402 to dead center field. That was a 401-foot flyout to the deepest part of the yard for Michael Burgess. He picked the wrong location to hit that ball in. And here comes Robert Andino, and a check swing grounder back to the pitcher his first time up. Andino trying to extend his hitting streak to 8 games, and more importantly, is trying to tie this game up at 1. A single would do the trick. Spencer will tear his rotator cuff off to send Eggleston home on any ground ball hit to the outfield. Rutgers football coach Kyle Flood will join me next half inning. We're in the bottom of the fourth, 2 outs, 2 on. Patriots trail 1-0, each team with only 1 hit. It's been a good pitcher's duel between Zielinski and Grenning. Grenning came into this game with a 4.93 ERA. You never know it. This ball is popped up into shallow center field. Backpedaling is the second baseman. He makes the catch, inning over. Coach Kyle Flood joins me next. Top five, Patriots trail 1-0 on SPN.TV and 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com. How's your family? Good?
Good. Oh, we're having a great time.
Good. Bob Mulcahy says hello.
I can't believe Bob's not here.
Atlantic lead that is TD Bank Ballpark. 1-0, Southern Maryland leads Somerset in the middle game of this 3-game set. I am Justin Answell. Joining me this half inning is fourth-year head coach for the Rutgers University football program, head coach Kyle Flood. Coach Flood, thanks so much for joining me.
Justin, I appreciate you having me here in the booth.
It's Rutgers University night at the ballpark as we're beginning the 2015-2016 academic and athletic school year. How excited are you for RU sports?
This is the time of year it really cranks up, and you know, vacations are over. We got our media days coming up a little bit later this week, and we're excited to do that and then get back and do what we do, which is, you know, coach and play football.
I know you love the gridiron. You have baseball in your background. You threw a great first pitch out there, and your son was by your side.
I appreciate that. Yeah, that was neat to have Kyle out there with me. And, yeah, you know, I felt the need to go to the mound as the head coach. I mean, you can't be throwing it from anywhere but the mound.
First pitch is in for a called strike, count 0-1. This is your second year in the Big Ten. How's the transition been?
It's been good. It's been good. You know, last year, I had said before the season, I thought it was important that we make a good first impression. And I think we did. And now we got to follow it up. We got to play good football. We got to each week go out there and work to be 1-0. We got a very challenging schedule. But when you have the right kind of players, that's the kind of schedule you want to play.
And, you know, do you feel like your players get up when they see Ohio State and Michigan on the schedule? Is it easy to recruit saying, hey, if you want to be the best, we're going to play the best, and you can be part of our program? Is it an easy recruiting pitch now in the Big Ten?
There's nothing easy about recruiting. Recruiting is a long process, and relationships have to be built. But the right kind of players want to play against the best. And in our division, in the Big Ten East, we play in the most competitive division in all of college football. We have the defending national champions in our division, and it's a great challenge for us, and I know our players look forward to it. And I know the recruits coming in, they love it.
We're joined by Coach Kyle Flood. It was just ground ball to second base off the bat of Rosa. So one out in the top of the fifth inning, 1-0 Southern Maryland leads. Here is Jamar Walton, an RBI ground at his first time up. Swing and a miss, count 0-1. Rutgers will get their fall practice underway in just about a week and a half. Joined by Coach Flood, are you impressed with the consistency and the winning culture that your program has? Bowl games in 9 of the last 10 years and 4 straight. You've been in Rutgers for 11 years, 4 as head coach.
Yeah, you know, I think it's something that the fans in the Big Ten have come to know about Rutgers. As we went into this league last year, I don't know how much people really knew about us or the fact that at that point we'd been to 8 bowl games in 9 years and now it's 9 bowl games in 10 years. And I think they like what they saw. I think the recruits like what they saw. And now it's our job to take that culture and take that tradition and move it forward. And I know that's the goals we have for our program, and that's what our players want to do.
And when a guy like Tim Wright wins a Super Bowl, that's got to be a great exposure for your
program,
yeah. Right?
Timmy Wright, Daron Harmon, Devin McCourty, and Logan Ryan, you know, 4 Rutgers guys on that Super Bowl championship team. It was great. Timmy was in my office about a week ago. He had the ring with him. He had spoken to the team about really off-the-field things, and I thought he gave a great example of what a Rutgers man can become and can do, both on the field and off.
2-2 count, 1-out, no one on, top of the fifth inning, 1-0 Crabs lead. Here's Jamar Walton, a 2015 All-Star against a 2014 All-Star in Matt Zielinski. And for as great of a success as you've had on the field, it might even be better off the field. Your APR is at the top of the world in the college rankings, Coach Flood, and you should be really proud of that.
No, I appreciate that, and it's important to us. It's important to the university. You know, from Bob Barchi, our president, all the way down, the academic performance of our football team is very important. And, you know, when that shows up in high APR rankings and high GSR, that makes us proud, and we know that's the expectation our university has for us. And we're more than happy to be doing it because that's really our job as college football coaches.
Check swing, fly ball into shallow center field. Newcomer Ollie Linton cannot make the catch. So 1-on, 1-out. As Linton will try and coax a double play ball off the bat of the catcher, Craig Maddox. I always wondered, as a head coach, is it really tough to watch practices? I guess you really have to trust your assistants because you only have 2 sets of eyes, and there's a lot going on in all the different practice fields. So what do you try and do during the practices and during fall training camp? Because you can only focus on, you know, so many things. I guess, you know, there's video and meetings later. But what do you try and do? Do you really trust your assistants? And you don't want to be a micromanager, do you?
Well, you have to. We have 9 full-time assistants in Division I football. We have 4 graduate assistants who also can coach with us on the field. And you're right. You can't see everything all the time. We rely on the cameras. We've got a lot of cameras filming a lot of different angles of practice. And it is what you said about the transition, you're right. It's probably the biggest transition when you go from being a position coach to being the head coach. When I was the offensive line coach, I spent the whole entire practice with one group of players, sometimes integrating with other groups, but with that group, and that was my group. And now I'm responsible for everybody. So what you try to do is throughout the practice, you pick things that you're interested in seeing beforehand. You have to script it all out before practice starts because you're only going to be out there for about 2 hours. You want to make sure you see what it is you want to see. And then the rest of it, you got to get on film.
It'll be an 0-2, swung on and missed, strike 3. So two outs, runner on first, one out, top of the fifth inning, 1-0. Southern Maryland leads Somerset in the top of the fifth inning. Here's the number nine hitter, Casey Frawley, flew out to right field. You like this family-type atmosphere in Somerset? It reminds me of High Point Solution Stadium. Good camaraderie and high-character people in the stands.
It's a great crowd. I live locally here. My family and I have been coming to these games for 10 years now. We couldn't be more appreciative of the Califer family and how we get treated when we come here. And we do love the atmosphere. And Rutgers night is really a great way for us to kick it off. I look out in the stands right now as we're talking, and I see all the scarlet and all the Rutgers shirts, and had an opportunity to be down in the concourse for one of the innings and meet a lot of the fans of all different ages, which was a lot of fun. And I see the sign as I look out into left center, of our Rutgers sign right out here. So I think it's a great relationship that we have between the Somerset Patriots, the Califer family, and the Rutgers football program.
How about Carly Lloyd? You got to be really proud of her. I know you're a football guy, but it's one big family.
I am a Carly Lloyd fan. There is no doubt. We were watching it as a family. It was an awesome tournament for her, but certainly the World Cup game was phenomenal. And we couldn't be more excited for Carly. I had the opportunity a couple of years ago to spend probably 3 hours at a banquet with her, with my daughter. And she sat right next to my daughter, and she couldn't have been more gracious to my daughter Isabella at the time, and I've always appreciated that, and I always root for Carly.
And it seems like Carly's still the same person even after all the success. I think that's what's got to make you really proud.
All
the success didn't get to her head or anything.
No, and I didn't know her when she was playing at Rutgers, but certainly the 3 hours that I spent with her that day and kind of watching the interviews she's done since, there's no doubt that she's well-grounded.
It'll be a 1-1 here, two outs, and they throw over and check on the runner at first. You ever get tired of the "are you" puns, or is it just really fun? The "are you ready for football?" Fans always come up to you about that. It's kind of fun, right?
I don't ever get tired of it. No, I don't ever get tired of it. And we will be ready. There's no doubt. We've had a good summer. I'm excited about the way the players look. We don't get an opportunity really to see all of it, but we see quite a bit of it. And it's exciting to see those players moving around the Hale Center right now. And I know 2 weeks from now when we start training camp, they're going to be ready.
What do you think the biggest jump is for a player going from high school to college? Would it be offensive line, you feel like?
Well, I think it's always quarterback.
Quarterback.
Yeah, quarterback is always the most complicated position because you got to be in control of yourself and the other 21 people that are on the field to really do the job right. But as a general rule, the closer you are to the ball, the more difficult it is to play early. So, positions like offensive line and defensive line, because the speed of the game is so much different than high school, they're really, really tough spots to play.
It'll be a 1-2 with two outs. Frawley at the plate. Crabs lead 1-0 top of the fifth inning. I am Justin Ansel, joined by fourth-year head coach Kyle Flood, 23-16 his first 3 years, taking Rutgers to three straight bowl games under his watch. As head coach, Rutgers been a four straight overall, 9 of the last 10 years. Check swing, did he go? They appeal. Yeah, he did. I guess he went around. Strike three.
The appeal was not heard.
Yeah. Strike three. Coach Flood, thanks so much for your time. Continued success.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
That was Coach Kyle Flood. Best of luck to Rutgers. You can hear all Rutgers game here on WCTC. We go to the bottom of the fifth. Patriots trail 1-0 in the New Talk Radio, 1450 WCTC.
Introducing the Samsung Galaxy S6 Active, only from AT&T. Tested to withstand pretty much anything life throws your way. Switch to AT&T and get a $300 credit with eligible purchase and trade-in.
Check your mailbox. You could find money in it. Money Mailer could be in your mailbox right now. You'll find great offers from local area businesses you know and trust, including the Somerset Patriots. You can also find all of these offers and many more at moneymailer.com or on our new convenient Money Mailer app for Android and iPhone users. So start saving money now and look for your Money Mailer envelope, which might be in your mailbox today.
Love your awesome wife, Kimmy. Kisses and hugs, she says.
Attention Patriot fans, Bridgewater is a proud sponsor of Somerset Patriots Baseball, located at 1244 Route 22 in Bridgewater. It is just a foul ball away from the ballpark. Bridgewater Diner is a great place to meet and eat. Stop by the Bridgewater Diner before after the game and enjoy great food and company. We move to the bottom of the fifth inning. Patriots trail 1-0. Crabs, two hits, one run. Patriots, one hit, no runs. This has been a great Saturday evening pitcher's duel between Brian Grenning and Matt Zielinski. Great stuff from Coach Kyle Flood. We wish him all the best for the 2015 football season as it's Rutgers University Day here at the ballpark. We're honoring Rutgers starting the 2015-2016 academic and athletic school year. Fastball away, count 1-0. Here is Nate. He popped up to second base, his counterpart, his first time up. The 1-0. Foul tipped into the mitting of the catcher, count 1-1. Somerset's longest winning streak of the season was 10 games. You know who it was snapped by? The Southern Maryland Blue Crabs. Right now, Somerset is in the midst of a 7-game winning streak, and Southern Maryland is trying to snap it. This is the first time Somerset's trailing in 1 week. Last time they trailed, it was last Saturday. Low and in, count 2-1. It'll be a 2-1 here to Nate. Low and in, count 3-1. Well, Grenning issued a leadoff walk in the fourth inning, but then survived unscathed. Somerset trying to coax a leadoff walk here. The 3-1. Knee high for a strike, count 3-2. Nobody out, nobody on. Patriots down 1-0 in the fifth. The 3-2. Ripped down the right field line. This will hook fair. Quickly cutting it off before it can get to the corner is Fred Lewis. A wide banana turn around first, but Spears will wisely hold it first with a leadoff single. Just the second hit of the game for the Somerset Patriots. Second straight inning, they have the leadoff man aboard. And here comes Hopkins. Hopkins has the other hit. So the two players that have the hits are the 7 and 8 hitters in the order. Hopkins hit a little squibbered on the first base line. Now let's see what Jody wants to do here. You could do the bunt. You could do the hit and run. You could just do a straight steal. Nate has wheels over at first. Somerset's already swiped 3 bags today. 6 in this series off Craig Maddox. A lot of opportunities and choices here. Spears not going. First pitch. Fastball in for a called strike. 0-1. Jody's not a huge proponent of the bunt, which I really admire. I'm not a big bunt guy myself. Now, obviously, there are situations that do call for the bunt, but I think you got to let Hopkins swing away right here. Greg has yet to hit a home run in the second half. Line to the netting behind home plate, count 0-2. This is the 17th game of the second half. He's without a home run. He had 7 home runs in the first half. Led the team in home runs. Still does lead the team in home runs. Nothing against Greg Hopkins, but I don't think anybody had Hopkins leading the team in home runs on July 25th. But this is not a Somerset team that lives and dies by the long ball. Spears on the move, the 0-2. Fastball runs too far inside, throw to second, not nearly in time. Spears steals second, standing up. And Somerset is running wild here on Maddox. 4 steals today. 7 in this series on 7 attempts. Maddox isn't even coming close. He's just being overmatched by the Somerset speed. Runner on second, nobody out. It'll be a 1-2 count here. To Hopkins. Ground ball, weakly hit down the first base line. Fielded by the catcher Maddox. His throw to first is in time. It's a productive out, though. It's essentially a swinging bunt for Hopkins. Going to third is Nate Spears, and here comes James Skelton. It's a 2-3 putout. Let's see what Clyburn does. I think you got to bring the infield in here. One out, bottom five. Crabs lead 1-0. Tying run 90 feet away. And here's Skelton, who has struck out swinging his first time up. Could do a safety squeeze here or even a suicide squeeze. Haven't seen Jody pull that trick yet this year. Infield is in. One out, runner on third. Single, stolen base, Squibbert in the first baseline. Righty pitcher, lefty batter. Can Skelton hurt his old mates in Southern Maryland? First pitch upstairs, count 1-0. Skelton. Hits 313 against his former team. The 1-0. Downstairs in the two-seam fastball, count 2-0. It'll be a 2-0 here to James. Nips the outside corner. Skelton took that pitch. Count 2-1. James, a high on-base guy. Career 391 OBP in 12 professional seasons. He has peaked at the AAA level. Tying run on third base, one out. Bottom of the fifth inning. Patriots trail 1-0. The 2-1. Low and in, smothered by Maddox to prevent a run from scoring via pass ball slash wild pitch. And the count's now 3-1. Look, if you put Skelton on, then you do have the opportunity to turn a double play. On deck is newcomer Ollie Linton, who's making his first ever start with the Patriots in his second ever game. He was signed yesterday, did not get into action. The 3-1 here to James. Infield in, runner on third. Patriots down a run. Swing and a miss, count 3-2. All right, Skelton's got to choke up on the bat now with two strikes and shorten up that swing. James looking for his 20th RBI this season. It'll be a 3-2 here to Skelton. Runner on third, one out, bottom five. Patriots down 1-0. Can Skelton hurt his former club? Yes, he can. Drills one to deep left field. It will be caught by Jovan Rosa. Tagging from third and scoring is going to be Nate Spears. He'll score standing up. 20th RBI this season for James Skelton. Patriots even up the score at one here in the home half of the fifth. Well, nice job by James right there. The former Southern Maryland Blue Crab hurts his old team with an RBI sack fly, and that's a great way to manufacture a run. Singled on the right field line, steal second base, Squibbert on the first base line to advance Spears to third with one out, and then Skelton with two strikes, didn't try and do too much, serve one deep and up to the outfield and left for Spears to score standing up from third via the game-tying RBI sack fly. That's beautiful baseball. You got to do the little things to make a big difference, and we're tied at one. And this is a Somerset team that has shown you that they can win in a variety of different ways. They can win slugfest. They can crush you. They can win low-scoring affairs like this one's probably going to be, unless somebody breaks it open real late. Ollie Linton pops this one up as the third baseman in the coach's box, adjacent to Shane Spencer, makes the catch, inning over. So Linton's 0-for-3 in his debut, with the Patriots tied at 1 in the Skelton RBI sack fly. Through five innings to the sixth we go on ESPN.TV and 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
This is Jersey. Things happen here. Big things. We had a kid from Hoboken do it his way and become chairman of the board. We had a girl who grew up in Ridgewood find the voice that made her an American sensation. And every week, millions of winning lottery tickets make people's day and change people's lives. This is what's happening right now. The Jersey Jackpot Instant Games, with prizes all the way up to $1 million. Anything can happen in Jersey.
Your wrist bone's connected to your x-ray. Your x-ray's connected to your orthopedist. Your orthopedist is connected to the OR. The OR's connected to your blood work.
With RWJ Health Connect, your secure electronic medical records are connected to your hospitals, doctors, and to the Robert Wood Johnson Health System.
And RWJ's connected to you. Register online for RWJ Health Connect. Better access for better health.
Steve Hossack, happy 12th birthday to Jimmy Fletcher, happy
We're all tied at one through five innings of play. Top of the sixth inning we go. It'll be Lewis, Stevenson, and Wilson due up. Great crowd on hand on Rutgers University night. We've already talked with Coach Flood. And here is Lewis. Lewis is 0-2. Both teams have identical three-column stat lines. One run, two hits, no errors. Ground ball behind home plate, foul count 0-1. Matt Zielinski just continues to impress. I mean, this guy had to fight to make the team in spring training last year. Ended up starting the All-Star game last year. Then this year, he struggled so much in spring training. Despite the fact that he had great credentials from a year ago, Jody Endomel did not think he was one of the top five starters on this team. He was the long man the first week of the season. And then Tyler Herron had an atrocious start against Bridgeport. They released Herron, and they said, Z, we'll give you one more shot. And after an awful spring training where his mechanics were out of whack, he even admitted it himself, he found his groove, he found his niche, and he's been dominating. Liner to center, played on one hop by Ollie Linton. Lewis is aboard via leadoff single, just the third hit of the game for the Crabs. As we're in the top of the sixth, runner on first, nobody out. Here's Casey Stevenson, who's 3-for-5 in the series, 0-for-2 tonight. And you could say that Zielinski was an all-star snub. I mean, a 6-1 record, a 2.43 ERA, third best mark in the Atlantic League. Only Jake Hale of Southern Maryland and Sean Bierman of Somerset have better ERAs amongst all active players than Matt Zielinski. This ball is bunted right back to Z. He's going to go to second, and he's going to, and the ball is dropped by Andino. Andino dropped the ball. I think the runner would have been safe anyways had Andino caught it. So that'll be a fielder's choice for Stevenson. Two on, nobody out. And here come the 3-4 hitters. So Z rolled the dice to try and get the lead runner on the bunt, and it backfires. And now you wonder if Zach Wilson would think about bunting here. With the number 3 hitter in the order, bunt. Game tied at 1 in the top of the 6th inning. Count 0-1 here to Wilson. Z needs a double play ball here if Wilson does not bunt. The 0-1. Not be made. They glance over and check on Lewis. This is a rematch of the 2009 championship series. Somerset won that one in 4 games in for a called strike. Count 0-2. So now with 2 strikes, you're definitely not bunting if you're Zach Wilson. Big spot here from Zielinski. Opponents only hit 214 against him with runners in scoring position. He knows how to bear down. The 0-2. Low and in. Count 1-2. Patriots starting pitchers have just been great. I mean, they keep the team in every game. When was the last time Somerset was just out of a game and they lost like 11-1? You can't even remember. Broken back grounder to second. This could be 2-4-6. Return throw to first. 3. Double play. Just what Zielinski ordered up. Runner on third, 2 outs, and here comes Opitz. Good turn up the middle. When you're up the middle combo with Spears and Andino, two guys with big league experience, you can turn double plays nicely. It's good to have Nate Spears back at second base, and that's his best position. He does a great job in right field as well. The starting pitchers have allowed 2 earned runs or fewer in each of the 7 games during this 7-game winning streak. It's getting the job done. When your starters go 6-7 innings and only allow 2 runs or fewer, you're going to be in the game. Runner on third, two outs, tied at one, top six. Here's Opitz, who's 0 for 1 with a walk. The 1-0. Low and in, smothered by Skelton. Count 1-1 here. Thanks to all for tuning in on this Saturday evening, whether it be on ESPN.TV or on WCTC. Game number 87 of our marathon 140-game season, the 2-0. In for a called strike, count 2-1. There is some activity brewing in the crab pen. Nobody warming up for Somerset. The 2-1 here in the sixth. Upstairs, count 3-1. On deck is the guy who's top five in the league in batting average, home runs, and RBI, and he's a righty. If you're a lefty in Zielinski, you got to go after the lefty Opitz right now. 264 hitter. Six homers, 30 RBI. The 3-1. Swing and a miss, and the breaking ball, count 3-2. Runner on third, two outs, tied at one, top six. Crabs got a run, an RBI ground out in the second. Patriots tally the equalizer in the home half of the fifth, and an RBI sack fly by the all-star catcher, Skelton. Crabs had two on, no one out this inning, but Wilson banged into a big double play. Can Zielinski continue to limit the damage and minimize trouble? The 3-2. Foul tip in the inning of Skelton, strike three. Two on, no one out, and the Crabs don't score at the meat of their order. Bottom six coming up. We're tied at one on ESPN.TV and 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com. BRB.
Longest drive will be our winner. Marty's going to have the blue balls. Lee's going to have the red balls. Marty, would you like to start? I think Marty's going to tee off first. Let's see it, Marty. Pretty good start. About halfway down. All right, Lee, see if you can match it. Whoa. Little to the left. That's all right. She's got the distance. Marty, here's your second shot. All right. A little wide right. So right now, Marty, your first ball is the longest lead. Let's see it again. Lee, how about that shot? It will stay in. Marty, you got to beat that one right there. Can you do it? Let's see it, Marty. Let's hear it for Marty. Marty gets no applause. Here's the shot. Will it roll? It's not going to have enough. Lee is not going to shoot that last one. She's going to take a bow, and she's going to win the Tara Greens Golf Center Longest Drive Challenge. Congratulations. In Route 27 in Somerset, it features a 3,200-yard, nine-hole regulation course, pitch and putt course, mini golf, and a driving range. They have on-site instruction, too. Visit Tara Greens Golf Center on Route 27 in Somerset.
Kansas City York Life win $5,000 Grand Slam inning. Our contestant tonight is Chris Pouch. And if the Patriots hit a Grand Slam this inning, then Chris is going to go home with $5,000. Good luck, Chris. Last ball, by the way, for the Kevin Apuzio 50-50 up on the concourse. And leading off for the Somerset Patriots, left fielder number 91, Aaron Eggleston. Southern Maryland's made a pitching change, brought to you by Dust Off. Strike out the dust in your home or office with Dust Off, a safe solution for dusty smartphones, tablets, keyboards, and all household electronics. Dust Off, keep it clean, keep it new, keep it Dust Off. Now pitching for Southern Maryland, number 27, Orlando Sentar. And batting for the Patriots, designated hitter, number 24, Thomas Neal. Thank you.
Two hits, one run. Clyburn must really trust his bullpen. In for a call, strike to Neal. Count 0-2. Neal is 0-2. First game in since July 4th. Missed 17 games, a left thumb injury. Runner on first, nobody out. The 0-2. Slider away, Neal lays off. And you talk to hitters, and you know, what's the biggest adjustment when you come back from injury? There's a couple things. One, it's trusting yourself. You know, trusting that sore left thumb that's been bothering the last 3 weeks. Two, it's timing. Those are the two key factors. And once Neal gets over those two humps, the sky's the limit for this slugger. Swing and a miss on the breaking ball. He was out in front, needs to get his timing back. And look, it'll get there, strike three. I wonder if Aaron Eggleston would think about stealing. I mean, look, Vidal has hit into 13 double plays this season. That is by far the most in the team. Somerset has stolen four bases tonight, seven in the last two games, and they've yet to be caught. I think you got to steal Aaron here. Vidal's a double play threat, maybe open up a vacated hole. Make something happen. Tied at one, bottom six, one out, one on. Righty-righty matchup. Vidal 0-1 with a walk. They throw over and check on Aggie, and they were kind of thinking the same along the same lines as me that he might be stealing. Swing and a miss, count 0-1. It'll be an 0-1 here to David. Eggleston not going. Foul tipped into the mitting of Maddox. Now David's got to calm down with that swing there. He was swinging out of his spikes. He was swinging for a five-run home run right there. David, calmate, my friend. And Vidal knows he was getting way too over-anxious right there. Runner on first, one out. Tied at one in the bottom of the sixth inning. Patriots would love to grab a lead right here. When the Patriots lead after six innings this season, they're 43-2. It shows you how good the bullpen is. Paul Smythe is warming up in the pen. The 0-2 here to Vidal. Foul behind home plate. We'll do it again. And look, if it comes down to be a battle of the bullpens, advantage Somerset. And they're without Buddy Beauchears, remember, who's at home in Alabama tending to some personal issues. That's all we've been told. Personal family type issues. We wish Buddy nothing but the best if he's listening or watching in Alabama. We miss you. Come back. The 0-2 here to Vidal. And he steps out. Fans starting a Let's Go Pats chant. I feel like we're at Gillette Stadium in Foxborough. The 0-2. Will not be made. They throw over and check on Eggie, who gets back in time. So Aaron will be guaranteed at least one more at bat. It'll be an 0-2 here to Vidal. Fastball away, count 1-2. It'll be a 1-2 here to Vidal. Liner into left field for a base hit. Great piece of two-strike hitting. Eggie stops at second. Two on, one out, and here comes Michael Burgess. Just lifted it over the glove of the outstretched arms of the shortstop, Raleigh. Two on, one out. Each team with one run on three hits and no errors. Burgess flew out to the warning track in dead center field his last time up. It was a 401 and a half foot flyout. It's 402 to dead center field. I'm telling you, you can't even hit it any deeper. It'll be a 1-2 here to Michael. Foul behind home plate. It'll be an 0-1 here. Burgess hit the three-run home run yesterday. Can he be the hero for the second time in as many nights? Breaking ball downstairs, count 1-1. One out, tied at one, bottom six, two on. Look, Somerset's had chances. Runner on third in the third inning, did not score. Runners on first and second in the fourth inning, did not score. Now they've got runners on first and second, one out here in the sixth inning. Can they cash in? Forced anywhere except home. Righty pitcher, lefty batter. Michael Burgess, the 26-year-old from Tampa Bay, Florida, at the plate. And the lefty calls time. Burgess is going well when he's driving the ball opposite field. Hit a three-run home run to left center yesterday. Runners on first and second, one out. Tied at one, bottom six. The pitch. Low and away, count 2-1 here to Michael. On deck is Andino, who's trying to expand his hitting streak and stretch it to 8 games. It's been a long but well-played 1-1 ball game here. We're approaching the two-hour threshold. Not even two-thirds the way through this contest. The 2-1 here to Burgess. And Orlando Santos steps off. Tied at one, bottom six, one out, two on. The pitch from the righty. Loop deep in the left field line. It's going to hook foul near the barbecue picnic hut. Count 2-2. Eggleston on second, he was hit by a pitch near the belly button on his jersey. Vidal on first, he laced a single in the left field over the outstretched glove of the shortstop who made a diving attempt in Frawley. The only out this inning was a Thomas Neal strikeout. Tied at one, bottom six. It'll be a 2-2 count here to Michael Burgess. A 243 hitter. High chopper to first, glove by Wilson. He's going to go to second for one. Return throw to first is going to be in time. He got him. 3-6-1 double play. Nice cover of first by the pitcher Santos. Through six, we're tied at one. To the seventh we go on the New Talk Radio 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com. BRB.
Scoreboard. Outside the book. Customer service, pick up your $50 gift card from
Visit Alpine Business Systems at www.alpinebiz.com. Alpine Business Systems, the official IT provider of the Somerset Patriots. Trune Associates, the sponsor of the launch here at the ballpark. At Trune Associates, you'll find more than a wide variety of competitive insurance products, and you'll find people understand your needs. Trune Associates is a team of licensed professionals who care about their clients. Let's pause for 10-second station identification on the Somerset Patriots Baseball Radio Network. Set Patriots won last night 8-1. We're tied at 1 through 6 innings. Each team with no errors, 3 hits, and 1 run. And it'll be a battle of the bullpens the rest of the way. The Crabs have already dipped into their pen as Santos threw a scoreless last half inning. And now Zielinski will be done after 6 innings. Gives up 3 hits, 1 run. He gets a no decision. And the new pitcher will be the righty, Paul Smyth, 6 foot, 220-pound, 27-year-old from Richmond, Virginia. Has peaked at the AAA level with the Oakland Athletics organization. Numbers for Smyth, 3-0, 22 games, 2.13 ERA, 20 Ks, 11 walks, opponents hitting 174 against the sinker ball thrower. Foul in the ending behind home plate, count 0-1 here to Gustavo Molina. Molina's top 5 in the Atlantic League in the Triple Crown category. He's one of the MVP candidates through the first 85 games of 2015. The 0-1 is ripped into the ending behind home plate foul. Count 0-2. Molina's 0-2. Pop up to the catcher and a strikeout swinging. Now, Southern Maryland won the first half Freedom Division title. When you win the first half of your division, you have the luxury of choosing what you want in the first round of the postseason. It's a best of five set with two games being in one location for games 1 and 2 and the back three being in another location for games 3 and then if necessary 4 and if necessary 5. Looped into shallow center, a check swing single for Gustavo Molina with two strikes to start the seventh. So one on, no one out, tied at 1, top 7. For instance, the Patriots chose to have the back three at home. So the Patriots will open up the postseason in the best of five series starting on Wednesday, September 23rd at a destination to be determined because we don't know who the postseason opponent's going to be. But we do know that on Friday, September 25th, we're guaranteed to have game 3 of the postseason. If necessary on the 26th Saturday and if necessary on the 27th Sunday, those games will be played right here at TD Bank Ballpark. The Patriots elected to take the home field advantage in the back three at home, and they want to open up on the road. Southern Maryland shows the exact same scenario. They're going to open up at a destination to be determined. Fastball, letter high for a strike, 0-1. So the Crabs, like Somerset, don't know their opponent. So they'll open up on the road on Wednesday, September 23rd and Thursday, September 24th, and come back home to Regency Furniture Stadium for a guaranteed Game 3 that Friday night in Waldorf, Maryland. The 0-1. Pop-up got jammed. Ball's in right center. Catch made by Ollie Linton. One out as Rosas retired. And for the most part, that's what you see teams choose. Take the back three at home from an economical standpoint and from a competitive standpoint. From a competitive standpoint, you always want to have more home games than road games. There's clearly a home field advantage. You got to love your passionate Rabbit fan base, and you like the idea and dynamic of being able to have a walk-off win, and more importantly, just sleep in your own beds, have your own clubhouse, not have to worry about the hassle of traveling. And from an economic standpoint, you want to have home games on a Friday and Saturday. That's a weekend. And you got to remember, the playoffs are during the school year. You're not going to draw that well on a Wednesday and Thursday. I mean, the diehard Pats fans will come out. But a marginal fan may be like, you know what? I've got schoolwork right now. I may not want to attend the game. I'd rather watch on ESPN.TV or listen to WCTC. So economically, it works out well. Foul behind home plate. 1-1 count, one out. I'm Justin Antwell, live from the Fullerton Auto Press Box. Thanks so much for joining me. Game number 87 of our Marathon 140-game season. Patriots just firing all cylinders right now. Winners of seven straight games. The starters, now for the eighth straight game, have allowed two runs or fewer. They're keeping the team in games. But look, tip your cap to Brian Grenning. He really mowed down Somerset the first five, and Santos induced a big double play ball with two on last inning in the sixth. Tied at one, top 7-1 out, one on. Jamar Walton at the plate. He has an RBI ground out today. Cue shot foul behind home plate. Count 1-2. After the game, win or lose, be sure to stay tuned for the Fleming Department Store post-game show. Patriots win, we'll have a guest interview. If not, we'll just go through the highlights and look ahead to the series finale tomorrow night at 5:05. We'll have a fireworks show no matter what after the game. That always gets the fans excited. That's like the common denominator in the Atlantic League, everybody's love for fireworks. The 1-2 will soon be made by Paul Smythe, who went to Kansas, played for the Rock Chalk Jayhawks collegiately. All academic selection to the Big 12. Throw over to check on the runner at first. Gets back in time. So he was an ideal student athlete. Kind of like the student athletes that Kyle Flood pumps out. The 1-2. Long set from Smythe. There we go. Curveball found in the ending behind on play. Count 1-2. Smythe's got a lot of run in his sinker ball. It'll be a 1-2 here with Jamar Walton, an all-star at the plate. For a fourth-round pick by the Marlins in 2004. Throw over to check on they got a pinch runner for Molina over there, excuse me. I was wondering why they were so preoccupied. Like, Molina's a catcher. He doesn't run well. They've got Anthony Vega pinch running. Why would you take Molina's bat out of the ballgame? It's the seventh inning. He's top five in the league in the Triple Crown categories. Must have missed that substitution. Well, Vega's over at first. The 1-2. He's on the move. Fastball away. Throw to second is going to be not in time. Andino drops the ball. If Andino makes the catch, Vega's out. Stolen base for Vega. Runner on second. One out. Takes away the double play threat. It's a 2-2 count here to Jamar Walton. The 2-2 with Vega on second. Swing and a miss, strike three. Swung at a sinker ball. Here's Maddox, who's 0-2 with two Ks. Maddox has had a really rough series. He's dropped two pop-ups behind the plate. He's allowed seven stolen bases. And he is 1-6 with three strikeouts. It just hasn't been his couple days here in Central Jersey. Two outs, runner on second, tied at one, top seven. First, they had him picked off, but nobody covered second. Vega was leaning to try and steal third, but nobody covered second base as Smith glanced over. Good thing Smith did not throw the ball, though. It'll be a first pitch offering here to the lefty Maddox, trying to atone for his poor defense this series. Foul behind home plate. Count 0-1 here to Craig. Craig is from Locust Grove, Georgia. Has peaked at the single-A level. Has spent some time in the American Association with the Gary Railcats in Gary, Indiana. Hammered in right center field and deep. Going back is Ollie Linton. At the warning track, he can't make the catch. This is going to one-hop over the wall for a go-ahead, two-out RBI ground rule double by the light-hitting 238 catcher, Craig Maddox, who atones for his poor defense this series with a RBI ground rule double in the right center field alley. So the Crabs have retaken the lead at 2-1. Swing and a miss. Count 0-1 here to Frawley, who's 0-2 with a flyout to right and a strikeout swinging. 2-1 Patriots trail now. Second different time they've trailed. Patriots are down 1-0, tied at 1 in the Skelton RBI sack fly. Now they're going to have to rally these final three innings when we get there. The 0-1. Breaking ball, too far inside. Count 1-1. Runner on second, two outs. Chopper in the third baseline foul. Count balloons to 1-2 here to Casey Frawley, former member of the Yankees organization. Never made it to the show with the Yankees, but was in their farm system for a couple years. Frawley won a championship with Lancaster last year. That was that Lancaster team that bested Somerset in the first round series. The 1-2, it's weakly grounded to third. Fielding it on the grass is Hopkins. Slings it across his body. And safe is going to be the runner at first. And Jody's going to have some words here with Manny Alejandro. Wow. Men on the corners, two outs. Wow, naked eye, he looked out. It was a slow ground ball to third. Hopkins fielded on the grass, slung it across his body, and one flew in motion. Vidal made a good stretch, and I thought he was definitely out. And they may yank Smythe here. Two lefties coming up. They may take out Smythe for Cayazo. That's an infield single. Men on the corners, two outs. Smythe is done. 2-1 Crabs lead. Top seven, they're threatening for more with the leadoff hitter Fred Lewis at the plate. Cayazo coming in. We will step aside for 60 seconds here on the New Talk Radio, 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
Sorry, we're closed.
What? I need help with my deposit.
The bank has rules.
It's really quick.
I can't hear you.
I promise I'm going to be really quick.
I can't hear you through the glass.
I'll be quick.
You'll be quick. That's what you just said?
Yes.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you. We're closed.
You know what? Okay, that's... Hey, sir, I just... Okay.
It's time to bank human again. That's why TD Bank has the longest hours and even stays open an extra 10 minutes for when you run late. TD Bank, America's most convenient bank.
Your wrist bones connected to your x-ray. Your x-rays connected to your orthopedist. Your orthopedist is connected to the OR. The OR is connected to your blood work.
With RWJ Health Connect, your secure electronic medical records are connected to your hospitals, doctors, and to the Robert Wood Johnson Health System.
And RWJ is connected to you. Register online for RWJ Health Connect. Better access for better health.
.170 against him. This inning started out with a single, fly out to center, strikeout, RBI ground rule double, infield single. Men on the corners, two out. Patriots trail 2-1. Paso throwing his warm-up pitches. Fans from the YMCA here at the ballpark. So three hits in this inning for Southern Maryland. Zielinski gave up three hits in six total innings. Innings one through six, the Crabs get three hits. Through two-thirds of an inning in the seventh, they have three hits. Baseball's a funny game. Where's Fred Lewis? You got to minimize the damage here. Min on the corners, two outs. You've already given up a run in this frame on the Maddox two-out RBI ground rule double right center. Long set from Callazzo. Lefty-on-lefty matchup. Long set the pitch. First ball is in for a strike count, 0-1. What makes this league great is matchups like this. You got Fred Lewis, a guy who's been in the big leagues for parts of five seasons, against a guy in Anthony Callazzo who's never even played affiliated baseball. And you can only see this kind of stuff in the Atlantic League. This is pretty cool. The 0-1 here. The young lefty against the veteran lefty. Men on the corners, two outs here in the seventh. Patriots down a run. Cue shot foul on the third baseline. Count 0-2. All right, Callazzo has Lewis right where he wants him. Now, you can't afford to bounce a breaking ball here unless you really trust Skelton. It'll be an 0-2 here to Lewis. Fred's 1-for-3 today, has one of the Crabs' six hits. And now time is called by Fred, trying to disrupt the rhythm of Callazzo. It'll be an 0-2. Callazzo really taking a sweet time on the bump. He does not have dinner reservations this evening. The 0-2. Foul behind home plate. 89-mile-per-hour fastball. Patriots looking for their eighth win in a row, but they're behind the eight ball. They trail 2-1, top of the seventh, two outs, men on the corners here for the Crabs. The Crabs are just 3-8 in their last 11 ball games. Capacity crowd on hand. The two-strike clap picks up. 8,164 on their feet. It's a season high here in 2015. Men on the corners, two outs. The two-strike clap will pick up again. It'll be an 0-2. And now Lewis calls time. What a crowd. 8,164 on hand. That is tremendous. The 0-2. Long set from Callazzo, the pitch. Ground ball to second. Pulling an outside pitch was Lewis. Throw to first in time, inning over. Men in the corners, two outs, and Callazzo strands a pair. Get up and stretch your extremities if you're watching or listening on your couch at home. Patriots trail 2-1, bottom seven coming up on the New Talk Radio, 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
Attention, New Jersey camps! It's time to start thinking about your summer schedule and field trips for your campers. The Somerset Patriots camp days have returned for the upcoming season. Head over to TD Bank Ballpark in Bridgewater to check out top-notch baseball for the best price in town. The 2015 camp days are officially set for Wednesday, July 15th, Thursday, August 6th, and Tuesday, August 11th. The Patriots are welcoming camps with groups of all sizes to come out to the ballpark to enjoy America's favorite pastime. Each game begins at 11:05 a.m. and tickets start at just $8. There are also lunch options available for just $5. In addition, each camp in attendance will be welcomed with a public address announcement and a scoreboard announcement during the game. Camps can also take advantage of our on-field programs throughout the game based on availability. So book now to ensure a memorable, baseball-filled, fun-in-the-sun trip for your camp today. Give us a call at 908-252-0700 or visit SomersetPatriots.com to lock down your camp's perfect summer trip.
Get the Gasway Idea Cam on your team by calling them today at 973-857-4440. That's one call. It'll save you money. The Somerset County Education Association supports the outstanding public school employees that make your child's education possible. Bottom seven we go. Patriots trail 2-1. Orlando Santos remains in the hill for his second inning of work. He'll face Andino, Spears, and Hopkins. 6-7-8 in the order. Patriots trail 2-1, bottom seven, down to their final nine outs as they try and expand their winning streak to eight games. Difference in this game, a two-out RBI double by the light-hitting catcher, Craig Maddox. A 238 hitter hit the go-ahead RBI double off Smythe last inning. In for a called strike in the changeup, 0-1. All right, Somerset should know what Santos has been throwing here. They saw him yesterday for an inning. They saw him in the sixth inning for an inning. Now he's back out for the seventh inning for an inning. The 0-1, laced in the left field. This will get down for a base. Hit an eight-game hitting streak for Robert Andino. So this is the fourth different inning the Patriots have had the leadoff man aboard. And they've only scored in one of the three prior innings. Spears is a very good bunter. He's 1-for-2 today with a run score and a stolen base. Fastball away, count 1-0. Nate hitting 275 on the season. He turned this season around with a great month of June. Hit 347 that month. Hitting 284 in July. The 1-0. Poke down the right field line. Foul count 1-1. Nate, 30 years old from Noblesville, Indiana. Originally born in Florida. It'll be a 1-1 here. Throw over to check on Andino. Gets back in time. It'll be a 1-1 here to Nate. And he drops a bunt on the third baseline. Fielded by Santos. Throw to first. Just in time. Got him. Nearly collided with the third baseman who charged in as well. Almost a disaster for Southern Maryland. But Santos had enough mustard in the throw to hurl over to first. Nate will get a sack bunt on that one. And here's the Hopper. Hopper's 1-for-2 with two stolen bases. 2-1 Crabs lead. Bottom 7-1 out. A single ties this puppy up. Somerset overcame a 1-0 deficit. Now they're trying to overcome a 2-1 deficit. This team is so resilient, so blue-collar, never-say-die attitude. Andino at second, average speed, one out. Single doesn't necessarily score him. Foul behind home plate, count 0-1. It'll be an 0-1 here to Hopkins. Greg is fourth in the team in RBI. Hit to deep left field. Going back is Rosa. Warning track wall. It's gone. Go ahead. Two-run home run for Greg Hopkins. His team leading eighth home run of the season. His first home run of the second half. It could not come at a more opportune time. Touch them all. Andino scores. Hopkins scores. Patriots now lead 3-2 here in the seventh. Oh, he turned an inside fastball. The hopper comes up clutch, and he's mobbed in the dugout by his teammates. And he is all pumped up. Good stuff from Craig Hopkins. Team leading eighth home run of the season. Dugout is fired up. He just turned an inside fastball and hooked it fair. It banged off the second wall and bounced back in the field of play. But if it hits off the second wall, it's an automatic homer, and that was the case. No doubt about it. Foul behind home plate, 0-1. Look, you knew Somerset was going to get to Orlando Santos. This is his third inning of relief work in this series. One yesterday, now two today. And I don't know why Clyburn keeps going to him. He's a good pitcher, but relievers can get exposed when they're overused a little bit. Especially a cerebral team like Somerset, who's always charting pitches, always keeping black binders and books on who's throwing what pitches and what tendencies in certain counts. And Hopkins made Santos pay on an inside fastball. Drilled it deep to left. 3-2, Somerset leads. Swing and a miss, count 0-2 here to Skelty. Skelton loops it foul to the left field line in the tarp area, count 0-2. How about the resiliency for Somerset? It'll be an 0-2 here to Skelton. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Two outs. I just love the resiliency. This was tied at one. Smythe gives up a two-out RBI double to a weak-hitting catcher. But the Patriots' offense just picks everyone up. Amazing. It's been going on all year. Greg Hopkins, just the man. Here's Ali Linton. He's 0-for-3 in his Somerset debut. Ali is a very tiny man at 5'8", 180 pounds. There's some small guys in this team. Jose Garcia, James Skelton, Ali Linton, Johnny Tucker. There's also a big man at the back end of the pen in John Hunton, who we could be seeing soon. Low and in, count 1-0. For the most part, baseball players are usually pretty big guys. I mean, Sattler 6'3" in the pen. Newby 6'4". Fastball away, count 2-0. They're a lot bigger than you think when you watch them on TV. But every single member of the Patriots in the top step of the dugout. I mean, this team has wrapped up everything they've ever wanted. And these guys are into it. The 2-0 here to Ali. Check swing, did he go? Yes, he did, says Freddy DeJesus. Count 2-1. It looks like Ali's going to call for some more pine tar. It'll be a 2-1 here to Ali Linton. Out of UC Irvine, played for the Anteaters. And a wild pitch is thrown from the bullpen. Who's warming up out there? Is that Andrew Kerrigan again? It is. Kerrigan struck out the side yesterday. It'll be a 2-1 here to Ali. Two outs, no one on. 3-2 Patriots lead, bottom seven. A 2-1. Looped into left field. First career hit as a member of the Somerset Patriots for Ali Linton. Save that baseball. Here's Aaron Eggleston. Chance to extend his hitting streak to 21 games. Left fielder, number 91,
Wilson.
Eggie sitting at a 20-game hitting streak. Look, this might be his final at-bat of the game. We might have the bottom of the ninth inning. He needs to get a hit here. We're in the bottom of the seventh, and the home team is leading 3-2. He's on the home team of Somerset. This could be very well be his final at-bat. He's 0-for-1 with a walk and a hit by pitch. Sitting at a 20-game hitting streak. The longest in league history is 31. The longest in Patriot history is 27. It'll be a 1-0. Linton on first, two outs. Throw for a check on Ollie. Ollie's got really good speed. That's part of the reason why they brought him over. Runner on the move, fastball downstairs, throw to second is going to be not in time. It's a stolen base for Ollie Linton. Look, that's why they brought him here. Little veteran speed. And here comes Eggie with a 2-0 count, two outs and a runner on second. Patriots lead 3-2. This is when Aaron Eggleston thrives. With two outs and runners in scoring position, Aaron Eggleston, just a tremendous hitter this season. Eggie, 14 for 28 in these situations. The fastball that gets to the backstop. And going to third is Ollie Linton. Count 3-0. Look, if Eggleston walks here, the hitting streak's over. I think you got to let him swing here. 3-0 count, two outs. He's got to swing. And they intentionally walked Aaron Eggleston. Oh, my goodness. The hitting streak might come to an end after an 0-for-1 performance. Oh, my goodness. Ah, my heart just drops. He gets intentionally walked. Oh, goodness. Men on the corners, two outs. I'm sick to my stomach. Popped up foul behind home plate. Out of play, count 0-1. I mean, look, Somerset really needs to get a lot of at-bats here in the seventh and then get a few more at-bats in the eighth so Eggie can get another at-bat here. Or they need to blow the lead so we can have the bottom of the ninth. I'm just joking. Aaron is 0-for-1 today with a walk, a hit by pitch, and an intentional walk. And with that, the 20-game hitting streak might be over. Kind of an anticlimactic weak way to go about it, but it'll be an 0-2 here to Neal. Oh, that plunked him on the wrist. And Neal gets plunked on the wrist, and now the trainer's out to check on him. Neal just missed the last 17 games with a left thumb injury, and now he gets plunked on the wrist, and Neal's in pain. I heard that from here. Now, what hand is it? His back's to me. I can't tell what hand. It looks like it's his right hand. Oh, goodness. Base is loaded, two outs. Patriots lead 3-2, bottom of the seventh. And Neal, who had missed the last 17 games with a left thumb injury, gets plunked on the right wrist. Will he stay in this game or not? The trainer, Hiroshi Roberts, is out to tend to him. Santos just all over the place. Let's see if Neal stays in this game or not. The trainer walked him down to first base, and he stays in the game. Two outs. Base is loaded. 3-2 Somerset leads bottom of the seventh inning. Difference in this game is a two-run home run in this inning by Greg Hopkins. It's been a long inning. Single by Andino to left, Spears sack bunt, two-run homer by Hopkins, Skelton struck out, Single by Ollie Linton through the left side. Intentional walk to Eggie. Hit by pitch to Neal. And here's Vidal. First pitch to Vidal is low and in, count 1-0. Vidal has 7 RBI in his last 2 games, the 1-0. Ground ball to third. They're going to step on the back for the unassisted fielder's choice, inning over. Through 7, Patriots lead 3-2. To the 8th we go on the New Talk Radio, 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
R.J. Seidel. 4 1/4, get him up. 4 1/4, 4 1/4, 4 1/2, 4 1/2, 4 1/2, sold for 25. Buyer number 183, 183. Johnny Tucker. 4 1/4, 4 1/2, 475, 500, 500, 5 1/4, 5 1/4, sold for $500 here. 297, 297. Greg Hopkins. 475, 475, get him up. 475, sold for $150. 297, once again, 297. We got Aaron Eggleston. 7 1/4, get him up. 7 1/4, get him up. 7 1/4, sold $700. Buyer 48, buyer number 48.
300. Joe, what are you doing? You're supposed to auction off the jerseys, not the players.
I'm so sorry. All sales are final.
This is Joe Bodner of Bodner's Auction Sales. Join me at TD Bank Ballpark on Sunday, July 26. We'll be auctioning off Patriots jerseys to benefit Operation Shoebox, New Jersey. We'll see you there.
All right, this one just in. We're selling Sparky Lyle. What if we get about 24? What if we get about 24? Get about 24? I just sold Sparky Lyle.
Need to hire technical professionals? Spearhead Staffing is Somerset County's award-winning IT staffing recruiting company. Visit them at spearheadstaffing.com. That's spearheadstaffing.com. Shopping for a new car? Hit a home run with all the great deals available now at your Tri-State Ford dealer. Proud sponsor of Somerset Patriots Baseball. Visit tristateford.com for more information today. Mike Lawrence producing on our radio side of things. Pat McManus and Mark Schwartz doing a great job on our TV side of things. We're through 7 innings of play, each team with no errors, each team with 6 hits, but the Patriots lead 3-2 because of the Greg Hopkins go-ahead 2-run home run last half inning off reliever Orlando Santos. Speaking of relievers, we had a new reliever in for Somerset. Smythe is done. He'd be eligible for the win. And in to pitch for Somerset will be Andrew Kerrigan, 5'11", 235-pound, 27-year-old from Norwich, Connecticut. Andrew struck out the side last night. He's really been playing well. Numbers for Kerrigan, 1-2, 29, 1-2 record, 29 games, 3.68 ERA. His ERA is 3.68. That is the second worst ERA on the team. His ERA is 3.68. Folks, that's extremely, extremely good. That just tells you how dominant Somerset's pitching is when one of your worst ERAs on the team is 3.68. Now, look, you don't really trust a reliever based upon his ERA because they pitch in such small sample sizes. You know, one bad outing can really skew your ERA. You would need like 8 really good ones to get it back to respectability as a reliever because you're not getting as many innings to make up for the runs that you give up because you're only pitching 1 or 2 innings at a time. I feel like I'm teaching math right now. Meanwhile, you know, starters, they're going 6-7 innings deep, so which increases their sample size of innings. So if they do give up runs, at least they have more innings to work with. I hope I explained that right. I'm not a teacher. The 1-1, low and in, count 2-1 here. So 8 batters come to the plate in the 7th inning, yet only 2 runs score. Felt like Somerset should have gotten some more. Here's Stevenson, 2-3-4 in the order due up against Kerrigan. 3-2 Patriots lead, top 8, nobody out, nobody on. This ball's hit deep to right field. Going back is Burgess at the warning track. Makes the catch as he runs into the Patriots bullpen. Just slightly getting under that one was Casey Stevenson. So Andrew Kerrigan got away with a hanging breaking ball. Just missed squaring up that one was Casey. A long F9 put at it for scoring at home. Patriots 5 outs away from victory. And here comes the number 3 hitter in the order, Zach Wilson. Now remember, they pinch ran for Gustavo Molina, their best hitter. So Molina's bat is no longer in this game, and you might really need him later on. I didn't think it was a wise move at the time, and it definitely doesn't not prove to be a wise move now. Low and away, count 2-0 here. Kerrigan went to the University of North Carolina. Interesting story he told me a couple weeks ago. We had him on the postgame show as the Patriots lead 3-2, one out, no one on, top 8. Righty batter, and Wilson is 0-for-3 at the plate. Kerrigan grew up kind of a wild child, had a scruffy beard and long hair in high school. Inside, count 3-0. But he pledges commitment to the University of North Carolina. And at UNC, they abide by the New York Yankees haircut rules, where you've got to be clean-shaven, no beards, no 5 o'clock shadows, no funky haircuts, you know, just a clean-cut look, like your textbook supercuts look. So he cleaned up his act for 4 years while he went to college. And then, fittingly, he got drafted by the Oakland A's, who were known for kind of their quirky haircuts and rough-looking players. You know, they had Mark McGwire and Jose Canseco, and they've had Johnny Gomes, and Josh Riddick is kind of a rough-looking guy, Grant Balfour. And then, so he grew out his hair there, and he's kept it grown out. Somerset does not have those Yankee rules. Hit to deep right. Burgess on the warning track of the wall. It's gone. Oh, an opposite field home run by Wilson. Ties this game at 3 here in the 8th. How did that carry? I thought the previous ball hit to right was better hit than that one. An opposite field laser. Deep to right. Clears the first wall. Deposit over the right field wall. We're all tied at 3. Zach Wilson comes through. Look, when Andrew Kerrigan's throwing 95 miles per hour, if you generate some sort of bat speed, the ball's going to go. Fifth home run of the season for Zach Wilson. Oh, ties the game at 3. It's been a seesaw affair. Crabs led 1-0, tied at 1 then. Crabs led 2-1, Patriots led 3-2. Now we're tied at 3 here in the 8th. ...2-0 count here. And I think Andrew's frustrated about the fact that he just gave up that home run, because those last two pitches weren't even close. How did that get out? What strength by Wilson. Well, I was kind of joking, the 2-0 upstairs count 3-0. I was kind of joking that Aaron Eggleston's hitting streak might end. Because if the Patriots held his 3-2 lead, he probably wasn't going to bat in the bottom of the 8th, and then Hunton would have notched the save in the top of the 9th inning, and his hitting streak would have snapped with an 0-for-1 performance with 2 walks and a hit by pitch. It's a 4-pitch walk to Opitz. Now, if this game just keeps going, Aaron's going to get another at-bat. It's funny how baseball works, I'll tell you. It would be very funny to me if Aaron Eggleston ends up getting like the walk-off RBI hit to extend his hitting streak to 21. When in reality, he should never have gotten another at-bat. I mean, I felt terrible when he got intentionally walked in the 7th inning as he was trying to keep his hitting streak alive, but that's the kind of respect they have for Aaron. Aaron's 14-for-28 with 2 outs and runners in scoring position. Dommel goes out and calms down Andrew Kerrigan. One on, one out. 3-3 the score in the top of the 8th inning. One out, one on. 3-3 the score, top eight. Here is the lefty, Anthony Vega, at the plate. Now remember, this should have been Gustavo Molina's slot, but now it's Vega because Vega pinch ran for Molina after Molina hit a leadoff single in the seventh. The score tied at one. First pitch up and away, 1-0. Kerrigan has thrown five straight balls since giving up the game-tying home run. I'm telling you, he's still thinking about that home run. I know, Andrew. Things get in his head real quickly. The 1-0. Inside count, 2-0. Six straight balls thrown by Kerrigan. Look, you got to take a pitch right now if you're Anthony Vega. 299 hitter, a homer, and 10 RBI. There's a strike count, 2-1. So finally a strike is thrown. Looking ahead to the bottom of the eighth inning, as the Patriots will look for their 18th win in their final at bat, they'll send up Burgess, Andino, and Spears. The 2-1. Bloop behind home plate. Skelton giving it a look. It goes six rows back, foul. It'll be a 2-2 here with one out, one on. 3-3 the score, top eight. Good matchup here in the middle game of this three-game set. Two teams that have qualified for the postseason. The 2-2. Called strike three, a blistering fastball, nips the inside corner. Down looking goes Vega. Here's Rosso's, 1-for-3 with a double. Two outs, runner on first. Jovan began the year at Bridgeport, got released, and he's found his niche here with Southern Maryland. Kyler Newby's warming up in the pen. Breaking ball high, count 1-0. Hot, humid day at the ballpark, 85 degrees. We'll have fireworks after the game. Tied at three. Each team has homered recently. Hopkins a two-run homer in the seventh. Wilson a solo shot in the eighth. Swing and a miss. Count 1-1. I don't even want to say it was the mistake pitch that Kerrigan made to Wilson. I just think that was really good hitting. It was a fastball on the outside part of the play, and the righty took it to right field, opposite way, for a game-tying opposite field solo homer. It just cleared the right field wall. Runner on the move. Fastball in for a called strike. Throw to second is going to be in time. He's out. Skelton guns down the runner. Opitz trying to steal. We go to the bottom of the eighth. All tied at three on the New Talk Radio, 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
We got one more. T-shirts off is brought to you by Health Quest Journal Patriots.
Attention, please. So the Maryland is going to pitch and change, brought to you by Dust Off. Keep it clean, keep it new, keep it Dust Off. And now pitching for the Southern Maryland Blue Crab, we have number 40, Cody Eckley. And leading off the home eighth inning for the Somerset Patriots, right fielder number 39, Michael Burgess.
All year, he struck out the side yesterday. I don't even want to call that a mistake pitch. I would just more tip my cap to that hitter. That was a good piece of hitting. All right, well, look, this is what Somerset's been doing all year. They get some runs, they give them up, they get them back, and they usually get them back and come out on top. Tied at three, bottom eight. Patriots looking for their eighth straight win. Burgess fouls it behind home plate, 0-1. Burgess hitting 241. Burgess has two home runs this past week. Five on the season. Tied with Matt Gamble for second most home runs in the team. Hopkins leads the team in home runs with eight. Just hit his first home run of the second half last inning. It'll be an 0-1 here to Burgess. He was the only batter not to bat in an eight-batter seventh inning. Ground ball to first. Bobble momentarily by Wilson. He flips it to Epley, who covers in time. Good composure by Wilson, who just tied the game up with that home run, and we're tied at three, one out in the bottom of the eighth inning. And here's Andino. Andino's 1-for-3 with a run scored. He's already extended his hitting streak to eight games. Now he's looking for his seventh multi-hit game in his last eight contests. Every month, Roberts got him better. Hit 186 in May, 276 in June, now 352 in July. First pitch here from Cody Epley, a former Yankee to a former Oriole in Andino. It's an AL East rivalry renewed. First pitch inside, count 1-0. The 1-0. Swing and a miss, count 1-1. It'll be a 1-1 here to Robert. Can he break this 3-3 tie with one swing of the bat? He already has two home runs in the month of July. Low and away, count 2-1. Righty on righty matchup. One out, no one on, bottom eight, tied at three. Patriots looking for their 18th win in their final at bat. Andino hits a high chopper up the middle. Glove by Frawley. The throw to first. In time, he got him. Two outs. And here comes Spears, who's 1-for-2 with a run scored, a stolen base, and a sack bunt. In for a called strike, count 0-1. The pitch. Loop down the left field line. Could this hook fair? Yes, it will. It's going to two-hop in the corner. Spears rounding first. He's going to chug into second with a stand-up double. Ball being bobbled in the corner. Spears thought about going to third, but he stays at second wisely. Runner on second. Two outs. Tied at three, bottom eight. And here comes Greg Hopkins. How fitting. Greg Hopkins hit the go-ahead two-run home run in the seventh. Made the score 3-2. Kerrigan gave up the game-tying home run last half inning. Now Hopkins can give the Patriots the lead once again. First pitch. Low and in, count 1-0. Runner on second, two outs. Righty on righty matchup. Spears on second. He'll score on any ground ball hit to the outfield. The 1-0. Low and away, count 2-0. Big spot here. If Somerset scores a run here, John Hunton would come in for the top of the ninth inning. This season, Greg Hopkins, with two outs and runners in scoring position, is a .233 hitter. It'll be a 2-0 to Hopper. He just gave the Patriots the lead in the seventh inning. Now we're tied here in the eighth. Can he give them the lead again? Curveball in for a called strike. Count 2-1 here to the St. John's product. Two-out double by Spears has prolonged the inning for Greg Hopkins. Fourth in the team in RBI, leads the team in home runs. The blue-collar third baseman at the plate. The pitch from the former big leaguer Epley. Lifted down the right field line, spinning foul near the lawn seating area. Count 2-2. Drama here from TD Bank Ballpark. A crowd of 8,164 is on hand. That's a season high here in 2015. It'll be a 2-2 here to Hopkins. Spears, big lead off second. Tied at three, bottom eight. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. The pitch. Ground ball up the middle for a base hit. Rounding third and heading for home is Nate Spears. He's going to score that a throw. Greg Hopkins comes through for the second time in his mini innings to give the Patriots the lead again. Patriots lead 4-3 here in the eighth. The Hopper getting it done. Wow. Two balls, two strikes, and two outs. Go ahead, RBI single up the middle. Greg Hopkins is clutch, and being clutch is everything. The Hopper comes through. How about Spears? Credit Spears with a two-out double to prolong the inning. Oh, this is good stuff from the Patriots here. This is what they do. Found an inning behind home plate 0-1. This is their MO. This is their moxie. This is their identity. They give up some runs. They get them back. They give them up. They get them back. They can keep alternating no matter what. But at the end of the day, they're going to score more runs than their opposition. And the Patriots are three outs away from an eight-game winning streak. Greg Hopkins, three RBI today. Ground ball on the first baseline. Count 0-2. I mean, Hopkins is a guy who's peaked at the double-A level. Epley's a guy who's been with the New York Yankees, the winningest franchise in all of sports. And that's what makes this matchup so intriguing. Hopkins got the best of Epley. Throw over to check on Hopkins. He gets back in time. Curveball away, count one and two. Two outs, runner on first, 4-3 Patriots lead. Righty pitcher, lefty batter. 4-3 Patriots lead. Hunton is warming up. He'll be ready to pitch. We have not seen Hunton since Tuesday. Fastball away. Count 2-2. Patriots lead. Loop through the left side for a base hit. Hopkins stops at second. Three straight two-out hits. Double, RBI single, now a single. And here comes Ollie Linton, who tallied his first career Somerset hit in the seventh inning. He's 1-for-4 today, making his Patriot debut. Looking ahead to the top of the ninth inning, Hunton would face Rosa, Walton, and Maddox. 6-7-8 in the order. Weak ground ball to first, fielded by Wilson, but it's in foul territory. Just kicked foul at the last moment. It'll be an 0-1 here to Ollie Linton. Two on, two out. One run already in. The pitch from Epley. Hit to second base. 360 spin. Throw to first. Got him. Good defensive play by Opitz. Ranges to his left. Hopkins breaks the 3-3 try with an RBI single. Hunton trying to get the final three outs next. Patriots lead 4-3 on the New Talk Radio, 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com.
Nothing is more important than your child's education. The Somerset County Education Association represents the public school employees that make your child's education possible. This includes more than 7,000 teachers, paraprofessionals, bus drivers, nurses, custodians, secretaries, and other outstanding education support professionals. Visit www.sceanj.org for more information. Together, we can prepare our children for the future.
And we can just throw the challenge, and there's no problem.
So I think Justin's probably my biggest threat in this game right now, but I don't think he understands what's coming.
I'm just thinking about Jerry.
The crying.
Where's this immunity item?
Jackpot.
And the third person voted out a survivor.
ESPN.TV is your official media network home of the Somerset Patriots, streaming 20 games a year, and we have got various different shows on the network. Through eight innings of play, the Patriots are three outs away from their eighth straight win. They nurse a 4-3 lead. Greg Hopkins, two-run homer in the seventh, go-ahead RBI single in the eighth. He's the player of the game thus far. Hunton looking to put the nail in this coffin. He's the new pitcher. The closer's pitching for the first time since Tuesday. 6'9", 245-pound righty from North Plainfield, New Jersey. On the season, the numbers for Hunton are as follows. 22 saves and 27 opportunities, 32 games, 1-1 record, 2.56 ERA. 24 strikeouts, 4 walks for Hunton, a 6-1 strikeout-to-walk ratio. Opponents only hitting 208 against Big John. So Big John is the pitcher. He'll face the 6-7-8 hitters in the order due up. What a wild game this has been. This feels like a postseason game, I got to say. Great pitching from Zielinski and Grenning. Let's not forget what those two did. But the story of this game, Greg Hopkins. Somerset trailed 2-1, bottom of the seventh inning. Hopkins' two-run home run, his first home run in 17 games. Then, in the eighth inning, after Kerrigan had given up a solo shot in the top half of the inning, Hopkins storms back after a two-out double by Spears that looped fair in the left field line. Hopkins stroked a two-strike, two-out RBI single, ricocheted off the pitcher's mound up the middle to plate Spears standing up. Cue shot foul, count 0-1. So the Patriots hold a 4-3 lead. The Patriots this season, when leading after eight innings, are pretty much automatic. They are 39-1 when leading after eight innings. Next pitch, a strike, count 0-2. Nobody out, nobody on, top nine. Patriots lead 4-3. Pop up, foul side of first. Vidal near the camera well, giving it a look. Reaching, runs out of play. Three rows back, count 0-2. Crabs are on the verge of losing for the ninth time in their last 12 games. Somerset trying to go 62-25 this season, 37 games above 500. Looking for their eighth win in a row. Looking to clinch this series, then bust out the brooms tomorrow night at 5:05. The 0-2. Ground ball to the third baseline, foul. We'll do it again. Great resiliency by Somerset. Can't say enough about Greg Hopkins over at third base. He's like a hungry, hungry hippo at third. He just gobbles up baseballs, great defense, and just clutch hitting. The 0-2, ground ball to short on four hops. Andino scoops it up, quickly shovels it over to his locker mate Vidal, and there's one away. Let's pause for 10 seconds. Station identification, the Somerset Patriots Baseball Radio Network. Good call, I forgot. Hold a 4-3 lead, one out, top of the ninth. Nobody on base. Here comes Jamar Walton. Rosa just grounded out. And this ball is grounded to shortstop on four hops again. A carbon copy play. Throw to first in time, two outs. Literally the same exact play to short, two outs. Patriots one out away from their eighth straight win. Somerset trying to go 12-5 in the second half. Crabs would drop to 7-9. Kerrigan would get the win. Epley the loss. Hunton looking for his 23rd save. First pitch. In for a called strike, 0-1. Look, Big John had a rough patch in about mid-May, but since that little hiccup in the road, he's been stellar. He's the anchor to this bullpen. The team's 39-1 when they lead after eight innings, trying to make it 40-1. It'll be an 0-1 to the lefty. Craig Maddux, a 243 hitter. Check swing, did he go? No, he did not, says Steve Leonardo. I agree. Count 1-1. Maddux broke the 1-1 tie in the top of the seventh with a two-out RBI double off Paul Smythe. It's a 4-3 ball game right now. We were tied at 1 through 6. Both starters were great. And Grenning and Zielinski. But they're just footnotes tonight. The 1-1. Foul tip in the inning behind home plate. Count 1-2. Can the Patriots get their eighth straight win? A crowd of 8,164 rises to their feet. The two-strike clap will pick up. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Patriots lead 4-3, top of the ninth inning. Nobody on base for the backup catch for the lefty, Craig Maddux. And now Hunton steps off to call time. The only negative note tonight is Aaron Eggleston's 20-game hitting streak will come to an end. Aaron went 0-for-1 with two walks and a hit by pitch. One of those walks was intentional. So he didn't even have time to extend his hitting streak. But Aaron's a team guy. He'll be the first to say, I'd rather have my hitting streak snapped than the team win. It'll be a 1-2 here to Maddox. 8,164 on their feet. This ball's hit to deep right center field. Going back is Burgess. Warning track wall. It's off the base of the wall. And it'll be a double for Craig Maddox. Wow. Hunton just missed giving up a game-tying two-out, two-strike homer. Oh, my goodness. Banged off the base of the wall in right center field. It's 365 in the alley. That hit off the base of the Bridgewater Common sign in right center field. Hunton got away with a hanging breaking ball right there. Somerset catches a break that ball did not go over the wall. And we got a pinch runner here for the catcher, Craig Maddox. Don't know who it is. Can't see the number. I believe it's maybe number 3. Tyler Wagner is going to pinch run. Get a little extra speed out there. Here's Frawley. He's 1-for-3. 4-3 Patriots lead top 9, 2 outs. Ground ball to the third baseline. Foul count 0-1. Player of the game, Greg Hopkins. He'll join me on the postgame show coming up. Patriots holding a 4-3 lead. Top of the 9, 2 outs. Hopkins with 3 RBI today. Go ahead, 2-run homer in the 7th. Then the game was tied heading into the bottom of the 8th, and he hit the go-ahead 2-strike, 2-out RBI single to make it 4-3. That's where we stand right now. It'll be an 0-1 here to Frawley, the 9-hitter. Low and away, count 1-1. Hunton's only blown 5 saves all year. He's yet to blow a save this month. Hunton hasn't gotten a lot of work lately because when Somerset is winning, they're clobbering opponents. The Patriots, coming into this game, had scored 8 runs or more in 4 of their last 5 outings. Only 4 today. I mean, I say only 4. Still a very good showing for the Somerset offense, the second-best offense statistically in the Atlantic League. Righty pitcher, righty batter, a 240 hitter at the plate in Frawley. The 1-1. Knee-high strike, 1-2. All right. 8,164 fans will rise to their feet. Tying run on second, 2 outs. 1-2 count, top of the 9th inning. Patriots are going to clinch this series and win their 8th in a row. It's a Saturday evening showdown between 2 postseason-bound squads, a potential championship series preview. The 1-2 to the 9-hitter Frawley with Wagner off second. Fastball away, count 2-2. Crowd wanted that one. I do think that was outside. Count 2-2. Any ball on the ground hit to the outfield, Wagner's going to be able to score. It'll be a 2-2 here to Frawley. Hunton one strike away. Breaking ball in the dirt, smothered by Hopkins. Count 3-2. Hunton looking for his 23rd save. That's not even half the total he had last year when he broke an Atlantic League record of 49 saves. Year prior, he had 37 saves. Fourth overall year with Somerset. Third straight year with the Patriots. He also is the architect to this team that's trying to go 37 games above 500 if they can get this final strike and final out. Trying to go 62-25, win their 8th straight, go to 12-5 in the second half, clinch this series against the Crabs, and now time is called by Skelton. We're trying to build drama as best we can, but these guys keep calling time. 3 runs on 8 hits for Southern Maryland, 4 runs on 9 hits for Somerset. 8,164 fans begin the 2-strike clap. Tying run on second, 180 feet away. The 3-2 with 2 outs. The pitch to Frawley. Dribbled behind home plate foul. Just barely grazing a piece to stay alive. Is Casey at the bat. On deck is ex-big leaguer Fred Lewis. We've got drama here. Look, these are 2 squads that already clinched playoff berths, but they're playing like everything's on the line on this hot Saturday evening towards the end of July. A 2-out double by Maddox has prolonged the inning. Frawley at the plate. The 3-2 with 2 outs. Ground ball to the third baseline foul. Wow, 9th pitch of the at-bat coming up here for Casey Frawley. What an at-bat. We'll have some audio highlights coming up. We'll talk with Greg Hopkins. Look ahead to the series finale tomorrow at 5:05 and give out some well-deserved thank yous. Patriots nurse a 4-3 lead. 2 outs, top of the 9th, 3-2 count, runner on second. The 6'9" Hunton against the 6' Casey Frawley. Frawley won a championship against these Patriots last year. And he loops one into right center field. Burgess on the run. Can he camp under it? Yes, he does. Ranging to his right to make the catch. 8 straight wins for the Somerset Patriots. Greg Hopkins, the hero, with 3 RBI in the final 2 innings. Hunton seals the deal. 4-3 the final. Patriots clinch the series. They go for the sweep tomorrow at 5:05. Oh, good stuff from Somerset. A resilient win by the red, white, and blue. Kerrigan the win. Epley the loss. Hunton his 23rd save. Hopkins the player of the game with 3 RBI. 2-run homer in the 7th. Game-winning RBI single in the 8th. This is the 18th win in the final at-bat for the Somerset Patriots. Somerset wins at 4-3. We'll talk with Hopkins next on SPN.TV and 1450 WCTC and WCTCAM.com. Is the hero. He joins me right now. We'll run through this game with Greg as the fireworks are going on. Other way here, Greg. We haven't had you on in a while. It's Justin Antle. We're going to look into the camera as we're being streamed on TV as well. It's Greg Hopkins, who is the absolute hero. Patriots win 4-3, their 8th straight win. It's Justin Antle. I'm joined by the player of the game, Greg Hopkins. Greg, congratulations. Great performance.
Thank you, man. That was a really good win. Wow, that honestly, that felt good. So it was. I'm glad we closed it out there at the end.
We'll go through this game in a moment. For you, how fun was this? I mean, these are two squads that have made the playoffs, Greg, but really, I don't want to say have nothing to play for. There's still something to play for, but this felt like a championship series title 15-round
battle. Yeah, I think so. I think the biggest thing is, you know, since we clinched, it's, you know, we still want to play. We still want to keep winning. You know, it's just because we clinched doesn't mean we don't want to, you know, staying fresh and you know, keeping our game at the highest level. But it did. It felt good. It had that kind of that energy. And, you know, so far, and we have one more game tomorrow against these guys, and we've had some good, you know, we've been playing well, so hopefully we keep it up. But it does have that energy, that playoff feel.
Well, let's run through this game here. Zielinski was great. He gives up one run in six innings, the eighth straight start now during this eight-game winning streak, where the starting pitchers, Greg, have allowed two earned runs or fewer. How much of a luxury is that for you, knowing that they're going to keep you in the game every time out?
It's phenomenal. You know, pitching staff all year has really been great. So just to be able to know that, you know, our pitcher is going to give us a chance. And we've been swinging the bats pretty well lately. And I know it took us a while to get going today. But, you know, fireworks.
Yeah, these are loud, yeah.
But, you know, they keep us in the game. And we got to try to execute, too. So it worked out tonight.
So Zielinski gives up a run in RBI ground out. But it seems like this is what Somerset does. You guys give up a run, then you get it right back. Because James Skelton was able to tie the game up in the fifth inning via this RBI sac fly. Greg, was that just kind of a textbook inning, a single by Spears, a stolen base? You do the little things like move the guy over, then Skelly comes through bottom of the order getting it done?
That was great, yeah. That was one of those innings, too, where, you know, everyone kind of just did their little job there, and, you know, and it worked out, and Skelly had a good at-bat, two strikes, I believe, too, where, you know, he got the ball in the air and got that run home. So that those are the innings that, you know, you score that run and tie the game up, and then gives you that momentum, and that's what happened there.
So we were tied at one. Zielinski goes out. Smythe gives up a two-out ground rule RBI double to the catcher, Craig Maddox, that makes the score 2-1. But there's no panic in the dugout, right, the final couple innings?
No. You know what? Like I said, we've been playing good ball, and I feel like that's contagious when you kind of, you know, you're never out of it, especially with the pitching staff that we have. And guys have been swinging it well. And as a team, you know, it's nice that it's a different guy every night, I feel like. And, you know, you just don't know what to expect, but you know everyone's going to have good at-bats and good things happen with that.
So it was 2-1, the Crabs were leading. We headed to the bottom of the seventh inning, and Dino extended his hitting streak to eight games with a single to left field. Then Spears lays down a great sacrifice bunt with a runner on second. Before we hear the home run call, I want to know what your thoughts on Orlando Santos was, because this is the third inning that you guys had seen him in 24 hours. Did you face him yesterday?
I did not. I actually asked Vidal, you know, what he looked like, and but thanks to Vidal, he said he likes his fastball. And his first pitch, he threw me a fastball away, and I fouled it back. And then I saw him shake a couple times, and I thought that he was just being stubborn and wanted to throw that fastball again. And I got lucky. And
he turned an inside one.
And he threw me a fastball in, and I, you know, I was lucky to barrel it. And it felt good. It really did, just to get that run in. And, you know, it was nice to go ahead and we'll take the lead there.
Well, let's hear the call right now. Here's your two-run home run in the seventh.
Nice.
It took advantage of an opportunity,
oh,
I guess.
Very nice.
That's your Instagram handle. But, Greg, you know, I know you're not a home run guy, but can you believe you're leading the team in home runs? This isn't a team that lives and dies with a long ball, but it's got to be pretty flattering to you to know that you're leading the team in home runs.
You know what? I've just been thankful for this opportunity this whole year to be able to be in this lineup and get consistent playing time. And I'm just glad to be able to produce and help the team out, man, to be honest with you. And it does, you know, yeah, like home runs are nice and all, but I just want to hit the ball hard.
Chicks dig the long ball, man.
Oh, man, so they say. But anyway, no, it's been nice to be able to drive the ball this year a little bit. And like I said, I just want to hit the ball hard, and, you know, home runs are always nice.
What's your career high in homers?
I think nine, but I don't want to jinx anything.
Okay, we won't forget about that. All right, so then Kerrigan gives up an opposite field home run. Did you think that ball Wilson hit was out? I almost thought the first guy who hit the fly ball to right field hit the ball harder.
I think so, too. But he has some pop, that dude. That guy Wilson, he has some pop. So he hit it good. I thought it was a good pitch, but, you know, by Kerrigan, and, you know, hopefully he doesn't get down himself. That was a good pitch, and he's a great pitcher. And he just – I think he – Wilson has some good pop, and he's squared it up, but –
So it was 3-3 heading into the bottom of the eighth inning, and then there's 2 outs, no one on, and then Nate the Great flicks the double down the left field line. So when you're strolling up to the plate, are you thinking, man, I have the chance to be the hero for the second time in as many innings to put my team ahead again? What's your mindset as you hear your walk-up song, the DJ Snake techno music as you stroll to the plate, Greg?
You know what? I'm glad you know that, too. I hope it gets you fired up in here. But
it does.
You know what? No, I really – Like, yeah, I felt good, and knowing that I had the opportunity to come up with that again. But, like, I didn't want to try to do too much, especially in a situation like that. I know with the base open, I know he's going to try not to leave something out over the plate. Luckily, I got a decent two-seamer to hit and was able to barrel it up, and it worked out. So.
All right, let's hear the call on your game-winning two-out, two-strike RBI single in the eighth. Walking on water there, Greg? I mean, what are you thinking? That's going
to
be awesome.
Come on. No, it did feel good. It really did, just to be able to help the team out there. Go ahead, especially with that turnaround where we went up, then we got, you know, they tied it back up, and then to go up again so quickly. It was a good feeling for sure. So I was just glad for the opportunity to be able to do that.
And here's how Hunton slammed the door in the ninth inning. A couple more for Greg Hopkins, the player of the game, 3 RBI. Patriots went 4-3 to extend their winning streak to 8. How much fun is this team having right now, Greg? It seems like you're having the best year of your life. Are you really enjoying it in Somerset?
Yeah, I mean, for sure. This is a great place to play. I didn't know what to expect coming here, and, you know, it's only been great things. So it's nice being around a great group of guys that have a lot of experience. And, you know, you can learn a lot of different things from each one of the guys here. So it's been awesome, man. We're gelling, and hopefully we can just keep it rolling.
The only negative thing about your game-winning RBI single is that Aaron Eggleston did not get another at-bat to extend his hitting streak to 21 games. I'm sure, obviously, I'm being facetious, but
you know what?
Did anybody think about that in the dugout?
You know what? No, but I'll make sure I congratulate him on that, because that's
definitely a
very impressive streak.
And how proud are you of Aaron?
He's unbelievable.
He's a great guy, too.
Phenomenal guy and a great teammate and a great person off the field as well. So I'm really happy for his streak, and I'm sure he'll start one up tomorrow.
You know, I asked Lucas Irvin this last night. You know, Somerset, Greg, I'm not sure if you know this, statistically is the youngest team in the Atlantic League. Obviously, you've got some veterans like an Aaron Eggleston, like an Adam Donnie, a John Hunton, Johnny Tucker. But guys like you, you're 26. Irvin's 26. Bierman's 26. Mm-hmm. Kayazo's 27. Vidal, your best friend's 25. Mm-hmm. You know, all the college kids that are on this team. So does this just go to show you, Greg, that age is a number? If you work hard and put your mind to something, anything can happen?
Yeah, I mean, you know what? I think it's one of those things where, you know, just – playing the game and learning, there's always room to learn, and you know, a lot of us have been playing since we were young, and having the pro ball experience does definitely help. But I think learning from those guys that especially have big league time, that's, you know, that's another level, man. And to learn from those guys, just to kind of watch how they go about their business and to kind of see how they play the game, that goes a long way. And I think that's where you kind of learn things on just how to go about your business every day. And because everyone here can play, no matter what level it is, no matter what level you've been to, everyone can play, and you can constantly pick up things on how to get better, you know, from here on out. So
this team is 62-25. You've got a plethora of really good players banged up. You just got T-Daddy back today, and you're finally starting to get those ex-big leaguers, like you alluded to, that are living up to the, you know, the hype. Gamble's really turning around.
Yep.
And Dino's stroking
yep.
the ball this month. How about Nate the Great? Fear the spear. He's a beast.
Nate the Great. Nathaniel.
what do you think the key will be in the postseason? I know it's hard to look 8 weeks in advance, but is it just about staying relaxed and treating it like a normal game, you think?
I think so. Because, you know, we can't hype it up so much. Right. I mean, we're going to be excited, you know. Obviously, it has that level of anticipation, and once you get to the playoffs, it has that atmosphere, it has that energy. You can feel it in the crowd. But I think we'll feed off it. I think it'll only benefit us. But I think, you know, Brett's been awesome getting guys, you know, days off and getting guys rest. He's really good with that, kind of knowing his players. And I think that's going to help leading up to the playoffs, making sure everyone's well-rested and ready to go.
You're a big-time player in big-time games. Greg, continued success.
I appreciate it. Thanks, Justin. Thank you.
That was Greg Hopkins. I'm Justin Answell. Patriots win 4-3 in a row. Final thoughts after this on CTC. We're going to say goodbye to ESPN.TV. Thanks to Mark Schwartz and our broadcast venue crew led by Pat McManus. Radio, we're going to end this after this.